The stage is yours, G-Man.
Booyah.
Looking very good today.
Looking
hey?
Gorgeous. I had to get dressed up. It's just me and the ladies today. If you could have heard the roar that went across the studio before we went live, we're in for a good show this morning. Absolutely love it. We're going to connect with our creative selves and find out from Jeremy Loops, what do the lyrics actually mean? Nobody knows. He will tell us. We'll
get it straight
from the source.
Because it's making such waves in the industry. I absolutely love it. Then our performers this morning, the Lady Gay Big Band, they're performing and they are going to take our Friday beautifully into the weekend. Levels. It's just levels.
Levels, man. And then looking... oh, to climb levels yet again. Ajax Cape Town having a very rough football season in the PSL, but they are fighting and they are fighting fit and they are here this morning, so they're going to put us through a few footballing skills, but also preview the Nedbank Cup. A lot of football coming up, the FA Cup as well this weekend. So great to have some of the boys
exactly.
here.
Exactly, and then we're going to try to get familiar with Liam Payne because today he launches a brand new single with J Balvin called Familiar. So we're going to chat to him on the line a little bit later on. I'm so excited.
Oh man, well, we are just as excited to see how Zozo is going to get us prepped with the weather ahead for today.
Oh, thank you, team, and a very good morning to you. Looking at your weather, temperatures seem to be dropping as we near winter with expected thunder showers for the Gauteng region. Now, temperatures in Polokwane starting off on 14 with a high of 23. Mbombela 16, 23. Pretoria thunder showers with a low of 13, a high of 24. Johannesburg 12 with a high of 22. Mahikeng 10, 27. Klerksdorp 8, 27. Kimberley 8 with a high of 24. Partly cloudy in Bloemfontein, 6 with a high of 22. Richards Bay, 17, reaching a high of 23. Pietermaritzburg, 14 with a high of 20. Durban, 20 with a high of 23. Mthatha, 10, reaching a high of 20. East London, 14 with a maximum of 22. Partly cloudy conditions in Cradock, a low of 7, a high of 24. Port Elizabeth, 13, reaching a high of 21. George 10 with a high of 20, Sutherland 4 reaching a high of 20, Cape Town partly cloudy, a low of 10, a high of 20 degrees Celsius, Worcester 7 reaching a high of 24, Springbok 8, 25, Upington a low of 11 and a high of 25 degrees Celsius. That's where we leave your weather, but let's take a look at what to expect on the roads. We start off in Gauteng in Midrand, where there's a stationary truck on the N1 northbound after the Allendale Road, and it's blocking the left lane, so please proceed with caution. And in the Western Cape in Athlone, traffic is slow moving on the N2 inbound, and that's from Airport Approach Road approaching Forest Drive due to an accident. That's where we leave your traffic and your weather for now. More coming your way in half an hour.
I cannot believe it is the 20th of April already.
The year is flying.
Life is flying faster and faster by the day. So let's slam the brakes on, as we like to say, and see what makes today momentous. What's gone down on this day in history?
Well, let's head to 1964. On this day, Bell's picture phone service dialed up the world's first video phone call at a New York World Science Fair, where science consultant William L. Lawrence was having a face-to-face talk with newspaper editor Donald Schaefer, who was in Disneyland at the time.
Hey? Disney had to be connected in some way. You see how freaked out that kid was. He's like, what is this magic? Oh, yeah. Then we move to 2008. And then 26-year-old Danica Patrick wins the Indy Japan 300, a twin ring in Montague, and becomes the first woman to win an Indy car race ever. Boom.
Absolutely amazing.
And she's gone on to achieve far greater things as well.
I love capturing these things and reminding us of all the amazing things that people have done on this day in history. So why don't you go out there and try and make today as historic as it definitely can be?
Oh, well, listen, we're taking a very quick break on your Feel Good Break for sure. But before we do, I just have to say good morning, Princess.
Morning, Zoe.
Morning. Well, she's making sure everyone is having their coffees this morning. But after the break, we'll take a look at Jeremy Loops explaining his lyrics. And of course, if you don't have plans for this weekend, don't worry. We'll sort you out with the 5FM team. We'll see you after the break.
Thank you.
kind of dizzy and weak in the knees. I've been in love before, but never like this. You're in my system and it's driving me mad. I caught a touch of your love.
Welcome back. You're live with Expresso. It's been a very long week. Just do a woosah with me. I know what you've been craving. It's not a weekend. You are craving the DJ Roger Goods Breakfast Show team in the house this morning. Sureshni Ryder, Miss Cosma, Robbie Cruz, and the Roger that is oh so good. He's now off the market. Stop your whining, ladies. How you doing, big guy?
What's happening, baby? What's up, baby? Yeah. Hey, oh, by the way, Graham, it's Ms. Cosmo's birthday today. It's Ms. Cosmo's birthday.
Oh.
Woo, happy birthday. You are one of the sweetest human beings on the planet.
Have thank you so much.
Unbelievable day. Please give her a big, big kiss from all of
us. Yes, sir, indeed. We are rock and roll. We are live with your gig guide. We have three hard parties that we have chosen for you this morning, sir.
Lay it down, man.
Coming at you first up, WWE Superstars in Joburg City at the Sun Arena, Times Square Casino in Menland, Maine. Hello. We kick off an exciting weekend with the WWE Superstars, Braun Strowman, Seth Rollins, Dean Ambrose, International Champion Roman Reigns, and the RAW Raw Women's Champion Alexa Bliss, Sasha Banks, and the list just goes on. The team champions are going at it. They are back by popular demand and promising a spectacular, non-stop, family-friendly show like you've never seen in your lives before. Friday the 20th of April from 8 o'clock, $465 gets you in. You got that, WWE?
And there's some big guys. We had them in studio. They are big. It's going to be fierce, man.
We can see them on your screen. My goodness me, they are massive. Wow. That's cool. All right. Second gig. Down to the mother city, your city, the beautiful city, Cape Town. 2018, the Ice Hockey World Championship is going down at the Grand Arena Grand West in Cape Town. Yes, sir, the International Ice Hockey Federation is bringing the 2018 World Championship division to our very own shores. The South African division are ready to reign their title at the famous Ice Arena at Grand West Casino. So get your tickets now and cheering for your favorite team alongside the South African squad's mascot, Rocket Rhino. You got that Friday, 20th of April until Sunday, the whole weekend from 1 until 8, about $30 gets you in. So it's cheap, it's rad, and it's happening. That's the 2018 Ice Hockey World Championships. And finally, we're down to KZN, Durban, the city of poison. What's going on, my babies? The Grand White Durban, that is what we're calling it, Durban, KwaZulu-Natal. It's the fifth anniversary of the Grand White, an event that takes place at a secret location in your city, and the only instruction is to come dressed in white. Obviously, it's an event where you arrive as strangers and leave as friends. You enjoy an afternoon and an evening of delicious food, live music, speeches, and much more. That's the Grand White in Durban 2018, and that is happening on Saturday from 2 till 10. $600 gets you in. What do you say, Expresso?
Oh, I love that, man. Let's give you our pick of our gig guide down here in the Mother City on a Saturday. The Galileo Open Air Cinema is hosting another movie night under the stars at the Nordhook Wine Farm, where they're going to be screening Bridget Jones's Baby, the third installment of the popular Bridget Jones's series. If you don't know the kind of narrative, a romantic comedy starring the Renee Zellweger and Colin Firth combo, absolutely brilliant. So bring your blankets, your picnic baskets, come and enjoy some amazing food for sale at the estate as well. Settle in for a very heartwarming romantic comedy, and that is on Saturday the 21st, obviously tomorrow, between $89 and $175 will get you in. It kicks off at 5 o'clock. And that's what's happening across the land.
I love it. I love it.
Oh, I love you, honey. Can I get a very special hoorah just from Miss Cosmo because it's her birthday? The madness. I always imagine someone faints. Well, South Africa, that's what's happening in your neck of the woods.
Okay, well, you know what that beat means. It's time for us to catch up with our local entertainment news in Mzansi Wood. Leanne, please tell me it's good.
Well, you know what? These troubling days where the online world is so overrun with negative relationship stories, it's so heartwarming every now and then to celebrate an anniversary that feels like a win for all of us. So local TV personality Roxy Berger and her husband Neil Schreger celebrated their four-year wedding anniversary yesterday, and she has been taking us down memory lane on Instagram, and we're loving it. Now, she wrote on Instagram 4 years ago today, I said, I do, and I would do it a million times over. The fashionista also posted photos of the key accessories that she wore on her big day. And of course, the couple welcomed their first baby girl into the world in January, Adrian. So, I love this. It makes my heart so happy to see happy couples.
Yes, and we need to celebrate that a little bit more. I feel like there's so much negativity around. It's good to focus on the positive.
100%. Yeah. Talking about focusing on the positive, I don't know how I feel about this next story. So from celebrating love couples who have stood the test of time to someone who is one of our most beloved musical artists in the country. Now, we all love Casper Neil Vest, but the rapper recently announced that he'll be headlining his very own show in London, and we're here for it. It's going to happen in August. It's going to be amazing. However, we were a little shook when he tweeted that he turned down the opportunity to see, wait for it, Beyonce perform live, and he said that he probably would have had the chance to meet her as well. Now, we all know that Beyonce made history as the first woman of color to perform at the annual Beachella Music Festival in California on Saturday, which made it even more shocking when the Doc Chevalier's star said that he was invited to watch Beyonce this weekend, but he had to work. Now, according to the tweet that Casper, he was invited to one of the shows by some of the lead singers. And then, of course, he would have gone backstage and met her. But he said, you know what, guys, I had to be responsible and, do the thing. I don't know. Like, I might have been irresponsible to go and see Beyonce.
I know. Hey. Okay, well, hopefully there'll be more opportunities.
Guys, I don't know if I'm even going to rock up at my wedding if Beyonce offers me a chance to come meet her. I'd be like, I love you, but I love Beyonce too, so.
Well, listen, someone else we also love here in South Africa is Jeremy Loops, and he's currently touring the country. In fact, he's promoting his brand new album, and it's called Curious. We caught up with him just before he left to find out more about his latest track, Waves, making hits across the airwaves.
Yo, this is Jeremy Loops, coming at you live with lyrics explained from my new song, Waves, of my brand new album, Critical as Water.
The sun keeps calling, and I've been chasing early.
The sun keeps calling and I've been chasing early to give me the coffee in the morning, a kiss when she leave me to get my day started. So I breathe in life and I get to another rhythm, then I'm in the flow, sitting in the back line waiting for the perfect one. So it's simply just kind of, it's talking about my process, a day in the life of trying to chase waves. I toured a lot in the last few years. I've been touring all over the world. It's been incredibly tiring. I've spent a lot of time in foreign, wintry cities around Europe. And that first line really sums up this first verse, which is, the sun keeps calling. And that was just because the sun was literally calling me. Like, I would dream about sunny days a lot of the time while I was on tour. So the sun keeps calling, and I've been chasing early just means I've been waking up early, like chasing down the waves, trying to find waves. It's not always easy to find waves. As you can see today, the waves are terrible for surfing. So it's always a bit of a search and a hunt. And give me the coffee in the morning. I can't survive without my coffee in the morning. A kiss when she leave me. I can't survive without my kiss in the morning to get my day started. And so I breathe in life. That's kind of like the morning process done, taking a deep breath with my coffee, just breathing in the exceptional reality that we are alive in this beautiful world. And I get to another rhythm, I'm finding my rhythm, then I'm in the flow, I'm on the way to the beach, and now I'm sitting in the back line waiting for the perfect one, meaning like I'm out at the back in the surf, I've made it out to the back, and I'm sitting there waiting for a beautiful wave or a set to roll in. And then the waves came and they washed over me. Which takes us to the chorus.
Skimming rock to my soul again. Pebbles on Long Beach, slowly turning into sand.
I want to be water. Skimming rocks in my soul again. Like pebbles down on Long Beach, slowly turning into sand. That's just like a lot's going on in my life at the moment. I want to be water. I want to be shapeless. I want to be able to flow easily through life. Skimming rocks in my soul again is like a throwback to Long Beach, the beach that I grew up on. Just throwing pebbles into the water and maybe a throwback to easier times in my life.
And the waves came, washed over me.
And the waves came, washed over me. And that's just a line about like this idea of the water almost baptizing me and just, I suppose, calming me down amidst a world which feels like it's gone crazy half the time. And I suppose that's really what the song's about, which is just the cleansing nature of the ocean and water.
As the riptide pulls me out into the deep.
As the riptide pulls me out into the deep, it surrounds me, holds me, formless when I breathe, but the air is clear and I am here. That's the bridge, and it basically just speaks about this idea of like floating out into the deep, the riptide, like kind of the madness of the world pulling me out and holding me there, and the ocean holding me, surrounds me. It's formless, formless when I breathe. It's just talking again about this idea of being encapsulated by the ocean and held safe by it. And the air is clear and I am here. And that's, I suppose, like when you're out the back in the ocean, the air is almost always really, really clear and almost just feels like it's revitalizing. So that's just a play on that that idea of the revitalizing feeling of nature. So I mean, my entire new album, which is called Critical Is Water, it's got a lot of themes about the ocean in it, I suppose. I was traveling so much in the last few years that I think I almost forgot what it meant to be, you know, like an ocean kid. I grew up by the ocean. I've spent my life walking around a little surf village in and around the sea. And to be in hotel rooms and like cities all around the world and spending so much time touring, I think I just needed to get back to nature, back to kind of what I knew. And so a lot of the songs in this album are heavily inspired by the ocean and my reconnecting to it. It just felt like water has been on my mind a lot lately. I inspire you to go and listen to it if you get a chance.
And there you have it, lyrics explained. Love that. Now let's get into a sporting mindset. Of course, for football fans, this weekend is all about knockout competition, as the semi-finals of the Nedbank Cup and the FA Cup take centre stage. We're joined this morning by two players I would imagine are feeling a little nervous but quite inspired for the rest of their PSL season. I'm talking about Mario Booysen and Siyanda Zwane from Ajax Cape Town. With us to give their perspective on, yes, the cup action. The silverware seems so important now in the context of both seasons. But first and foremost, let's get it out of the way, man. A rough, rough season for you guys. How are you guys putting it all into perspective? Where are your heads at now?
I think, yeah, we know it was a difficult season for us. It was a bit inconsistent. But I think the past few games, we played good football. It's just that, like on Sunday, the previous game, it wasn't the result that we wanted.
Margins,
but I think,
yeah.
So I think we have to take the positives out of that game, and going to the Tuesday game, we have to give the same performance, and hopefully we'll come out with a positive result.
Are you thinking about relegation? Is that in the mind even? Have you allowed that to come in there?
No, not at all. Right now we're in a position whereby the last three games that you're gonna play is more like cup final for us.
You
know, it's more now about the heart. It's how much we want it, you know. We know that we put ourselves in this position and we are the ones who are going to take ourselves out of it.
I'm so glad that you said that. It is in your hands.
Yeah.
I love that. So, obviously, this beautiful shining trophy. You know all about cup competition, drama, how frustrating. Made it to the last 32 in this case. But looking at the teams that have come out on top, let's start with our first fixture, Kaiser Chiefs, Free State Stars. Chiefs desperate for something, and that seems to be the story of the season. Everyone wants some silverware now because the season, the PSL is just gone.
Yeah, I think it's just a two-horse race for the league. But I think Chiefs is a big club and they want to finish the season with a trophy. But it's not going to be easy because Free State was also doing well in the league. But you know, cup games is totally different.
Yeah,
it's a once-off. So I think it's a tough one. But I'll go with Chiefs.
I think the sane man would. Then, very interesting fixture. When we look at Mamelodi Sundowns, probably one of the few teams that has had a dream run. I think they're on about 17 games unbeaten in all forms now. Can Maritzburg United do anything to stop that juggernaut?
It's going to be a very, very tight encounter. But I think Sundowns on the day. I'll go with Sundowns on the day. I don't know, maybe it's because they are very close to my heart. But I believe
you're
that
allowed to say it. You know, yeah, Cape Townians are friendly, man. We still embrace.
And, this, and Maritzburg also, because I'm also from Maritzburg. So for me, it's a very, very, I'm in a very tricky situation. But on this one, I'll, I'll go for Mamelodi Sundowns.
Sundowns, I think, have the edge. You're going to have to watch the game alone so no one can judge you. I love that. Then very briefly, of course, Arsenal out of the FA Cup. I know you're a big Gunners fan there, but my heart is certainly with Tottenham's Hotspur as they come up against Man United. But for Jose Mourinho, this really is it. Such a big spending season. A couple of those players offering a little glimmer of return on investment, but he's got a lot to prove.
Yeah, I think I'll also go with Tottenham because they were more consistent also.
They're just a better team.
Yeah, they play this better football at the moment also. I think, yeah, United is coming from a win now, but I'll go with Tottenham because they play well as a group and I like watching them.
Oh, I love that. Then I think, again, we'd probably give Chelsea the edge over Southampton. That's our second game there. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Thanks for fronting up as well. I think you know the situation that you're in, but it seems like the team has got the right mindset. So all the best of luck. I look forward to seeing you in the PSL again next season, man.
Thank you, man.
You can let us know what sporting highlights are standing out for you. Which football team do you think's got the edge in all of our cup competition?
Oh, well, listen, Joburg, I hope you are ready because the presenter search on three auditions, they are finally here. The gates open at 8 a.m. at the Wanderers Stadium and auditions are taking place today, tomorrow and Sunday, and it's proudly brought to you by Mac Cafe and Cappy Tech. Now, make sure you arrive, you're prepared with your 15-second link and you're ready to wow the judges. 5FM, they will be broadcasting live from the auditions and you'll also see some famous faces roaming around scouting for talent. So this is your opportunity not to be missed. So make sure you get to those auditions. It's at Wanderers Stadium. And for more details on what to expect, you can head on over to the website. That's presentersearchon3.com.
Well, still to come on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Don't worry, ladies, our Ajax players are still in the house. We chat about heading towards that top PSL spot. And then, of course, South Africa's very first all-woman big band is in the house, everybody. And they perform for us after the break. It's Lady Day Big Band. Yes.
One. Okay, thank you.
Welcome back, you beautiful people, and welcome to the gorgeous ladies behind me. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. You guys are in for a treat. We have got a very sassy, brand new Cape Town-based group called Lady Day Big Band in studio. A brilliant new concept, and from the sound check already, they are going to blow you away. And of course, they're consisting of the founder, a stranger to our show, Lana Crowster. Absolutely love her, Amanda Tiffin and Kelly Bell. The Lady Day Big Band consists entirely of professional female musicians, which is an awesome statement to make, and they're about to make a statement with their first performance. It don't mean a thing.
Must have something to do with you. Every time you're near me, my body gets hot. Don't need no doctor, I know what I've
affected me. Feeling kind of dizzy and weak in the knees. I've been in love before, but never so bad. You're in my system and it's driving me mad. I caught a touch of your love.
What a Friday morning needs, ladies. Thank you so much for that. That was awesome, man.
Thanks, Gail.
We love it when you come around, especially when you bring some friends with you. What's the vibe here? I'm getting a lot of sass. There's a lot of energy coming out. So it's quite a lot for this time of the morning to come walk into a studio and hear this awesome sound.
We've never had this much estrogen coming out. I know, it's amazing.
I grew up in an all-female household, girl.
Okay.
No, I absolutely love it because there is a deeper meaning here and I can see how much it means to you to perform. Yeah. With this band, what is the rationale here? Why did you bring this group of ladies together to collaborate?
So I've been, for 10 years this has been an idea. And when I was at UCT, I had the opportunity of singing with the UCT Big Band. And since then I haven't had the opportunity again. And I spoke to my colleagues, Miss Kelly Bell, the legendary over there on the trombone, and Miss Amanda Tiffin, who is my mentor and one of my best friends. And I was like, guys, we should do an all-woman big band. And she was like, they were like, yeah, let's do it. Called these amazing women up and it just happened. And I'm so grateful to all of them because it's a lot of sacrifice to get 18 people's schedules to coordinate, you know?
This is the first time they've rehearsed together, in fact, is what you're trying to say.
No, we've rehearsed.
No, I absolutely love it. What I love is you talking about inspiring a new generation. I mean, we've got to pay homage to the generation that is here already of unbelievably talented musicians. So thank you so much for bringing so many together. We absolutely love this. And they are going to stick around all morning, but you can let us know what you thought of that performance, a little jazz on our Friday morning. Hit us up at Expresso Show is the handle to use.
In the national news this morning, President Cyril Ramaphosa has cut short his visit to the UK to meet with ANC leaders over the ongoing violence and chaos that has erupted in Mahikeng in Northwest Province. He will be addressing an urgent meeting convened with structures of the ruling party in the provincial capital later today. The president was leading a South African delegation to the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting in London. Ramaphosa says he has noted with serious concern reports of clashes between protesters and police this week. Transport Minister Blade Nzimande yesterday appealed to all parties concerned to urgently find a negotiated settlement as the countrywide bus strike drags on. Thousands of commuters were again left stranded yesterday as dozens of bus companies across the country are affected by the strike. Taxi operators have been trying to accommodate the additional commuters as bus drivers have vowed to continue with the strike until their wage demands are met. They want a 12% wage increase while the employers are offering 7%. Now moving further abroad, in Cuba, Communist Party stalwart Miguel Díaz-Canel, who is said to be a Richard Gere lookalike, replaced Raúl Castro as president yesterday, starting a new chapter for the island after nearly 60 years of rule by the Castro brothers. Díaz-Canel was sworn in by the National Assembly with 603 of the 604 lawmakers present, voting for the 57-year-old. The transition is not expected to herald sweeping changes to the island's state-run economy and one-party system, one of the last in the world. And then finally, the King of Swaziland, one of the world's few absolute monarchs, announced yesterday that his country had changed its name to Eswatini to mark 50 years since independence from British rule, meaning place of the Swazi. Eswatini is the Swazi language name for the tiny nation landlocked between South Africa and Mozambique. King Mswati III declared the name change during Independence Day celebrations at a packed sports stadium in the second city of Manzini. Well, that was your 7 o'clock news update. Let's get a look at what's happening in the world of sport. Here's Graham.
Football, understandably, dominating this weekend. Let's get off with our local action. The final two teams in this season's Nedbank Cup will be decided this weekend as semi-finals fixtures take place across the country. Our first Kaizer Chiefs facing off with Free State Stars just 2 weeks after the teams met in the league, where, of course, Amakhosini secured that 1-0 win thanks to a goal in the final minute of the game. However, that other semi-final sees our league leaders, runaway leaders at the moment, Mamelodi Sundowns, up against Maritzburg United on Sunday. Then a little further afield, Chelsea's quest for Champions League football next season is still on course following a 2-1 win over Burnley last night. The result takes fifth place Chelsea to 63 points on the table, just 5 points behind the fourth placed Spurs, with four games still to play this season. But of course, Chelsea, setting that aside, they're in action again this weekend, but for cup battle. They battle it out against Southampton in the FA Cup semi-finals, while Man United, they'll be facing off against Tottenham Hotspur. Then finally on to rugby, the Lions and the Waratahs kick off week 10 of Super Rugby today, a little bit later this morning. That's with their clash in Sydney. The Waratahs hold that 3-2 win record over the Lions in their last five meetings. However, the South African side pulled off a very memorable 55-36 victory in their team's last met. Also in Super Rugby action this weekend, the Bulls are up against the Rebels, while the big one locally, the Stormers, up against the Sharks in our all-local coastal derby. And then finally, we round off with tennis. Novak Djokovic's journey back to form hit yet another hurdle yesterday as he suffered a shock round of 16 loss to Dominic Thiem. And of course, at the Monte Carlo Masters, Djokovic took the early advantage with a 7-6 win in that first set. Thiem battled back to see out the match with a 6-2, 6-3 win in the final two sets. Some other results coming out of the day's play: Rafa Nadal, Grigor Dimitrov and Alexander Zverev all moving through to the last eight. And that's where we leave our sport for now.
Well, let's take another look at the roads, and it's not looking good in Gauteng and Bedford View. Now, there's been a multi-vehicle accident on the N3 northbound after Van Buren Road. Three lanes have been blocked, so it's best to please avoid this route and make use of an alternative route. Then in the Western Cape and Bellville, traffic is slow moving on the N1 inbound, and that's from Yip de Jager Drive, and that's approaching the Kuberg interchange. That's where we leave your roads for now, but let's quickly look at your weather. And temperatures are dropping as we near winter, and you can expect some thunder showers in the Gauteng region. Polokwane starting off on 14, reaching a high of 23. Mbombela 16 with a high of 23. Pretoria 13, 24. Johannesburg 12, reaching a high of 22. Partly cloudy conditions in Mahikeng 10 with a high of 27. Klerksdorp 8, reaching a high of 27. Kimberley 8, 24. Bloemfontein 6, 22. Richards Bay 17, reaching a high of 23. Rain expected in Pietermaritzburg, a low of 14 with a high of 20. Durban also wet conditions with a low of 20, a high of 23. Mthatha 10, reaching a high of 20. East London 14, 22. Craddock 7 with a high of 24. Port Elizabeth 13, reaching a high of 21. George partly cloudy, a low of 10, a high of 20. Sutherland 4, reaching a high of 20. Cape Town 10, also with a maximum of 20 degrees Celsius. Partly cloudy conditions in Worcester, a low of 7, a high of 24. Springbok 8, reaching a high of 25. And Upington 11, with a maximum of 25 degrees Celsius. And that's where we leave your weather on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Effaflu C Immune Booster from Pharmadynamics. Effective, affordable healthcare.
So now, of course, we're going to have a little bit of fun, as always, Leanne, pouring through her social media at the moment. So good to have you guys active with us. And, of course, around this time of the week, we love to track our timeline, see what stories, what videos have jumped off the page and really got our attention. And we've got some magic ones. Zoe, do you want to join us?
Well, I don't know how magic this one is. Maybe magically, you know, it turned out. Okay, so video footage was caught of these two girls walking down the road as friends do, loving life and just being friends. And then all of a sudden, one decides to push her friend in the way of a moving bus. Now, the one friend says it was meant as a prank. Didn't think that, or did rather didn't see the bus there, but police were not convinced. Oh. You guys, she narrowly missed the wheel of that bus. This could have had horrendous, horrendous outcomes. The police were not convinced and
first
fined
was that thing almost falling on the baby. Now the woman pushing a friend in front of the bus. I cannot actually
and
what's deal with
dangerous. Don't
what's funny is
dangerous.
What's funny is I do that sometimes. I do like just like, push my friend, but like
yeah,
you know.
But not next traffic.
Oh man.
Yeah. Okay, well, listen, man, also something quite interesting. I mean, I love a good flame-grilled steak, but there's one restaurant that their steaks are so hot it keeps setting the fire alarm off. Take a look at that. They literally flame their steaks.
Wow.
And, ooh, yeah, okay. But you see.
No, man. Would, that
yeah,
is
yeah, you check. You asked for it.
They did ask for it. Oh, that's so funny. I want to see that again.
That is a lot of... Anyways.
Well, now that we've thoroughly traumatized you for this morning, that's what's been trending on our timelines this morning. You can let us know what hashtag, what video or story has caught your attention. As always, share your thoughts with us. Show us a little bit of love on Facebook or Twitter. At Expresso Show is the handle to use and the hashtag to use as well. All right, ladies, are you ready?
No. Okay, cool.
Have any of you stared at the screen? Do you notice how I left this there just so you could have a little gander? So we're going to play our favorite guessing game here on the show. It's time for Expresso Rewind. How much have you been listening and concentrating throughout the week? I'm not asking you. I'm asking our gorgeous ladies because they're going to go head to head in one of the toughest competitions known to man. It's Rewind. Ladies, what are those sounds?
Woo!
Oh, that's a good sound.
That's me.
Me. Oh. Sound more like, me. Come on, yeah? All right, so this one's very close to my heart. I think close to all South Africans' hearts. You know the drill. You can only make your sound once I've finished the entire question.
Okay.
Our first question comes as follows. How many medals did South Africa win at the Commonwealth Games?
Me!
Oh, I'll have to go with Leanne there.
Thank you. I think 37.
I'm going to say 32.
Okay, we have our two answers in. Booyah, 37. Should have said it with more conviction there. This was one of the, I think, cutest stories this week. How old is dancing instructor Ilana Slomowitz?
Me.
Oh.
77.
Are you going to have a gander before I reveal it? No, she's not.
77.
Hey. Boom. A point apiece, ladies. Eyes front, eyes front.
Never too.
Our next question. Which fruit can you use to replace eggs in a recipe?
Oh, no, I don't know.
Banana.
I'm going to say banana.
I'm going to give you both. Okay, I will
chia seed.
Split it.
Oh, banana.
Banana.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
I'll give you almost
half a point each.
I need to take that away from you because you didn't back yourself. Have conviction, Leanne.
Yes, be confident.
No, you're both sitting on 1.5, ladies. This is the decider. Come on, girls. What is the most common cause of anemia?
Woo!
Leanne?
Iron deficiency.
I was
going to
say iron deficiency too.
Booyah,
well,
Leanne is our champion.
With Dr. Darren, so.
Pat her on the back. That was an amazing performance.
Thank you.
Well
just
done.
Rub
if you got it right at home, well done to you. And of course, we love to give you a question to answer on our social media platforms as well. Our question for you guys at home is which two WWE wrestlers joined us on your Feel Good Breakfast show yesterday? Share your answer with us on our social media platforms, all of them, Facebook and of course, Twitter. And you can go back and check it out on YouTube, our very special YouTube channel. If you have missed anything this week. Sorry, I was a little bit distracted by our champion getting her just rewards there.
Thank you.
We're going to take the quickest of ad breaks when we return more from our Ajax stars.
And we make some cumin-scented carrot soup, and that is with our veggie bullet. All that more coming up on your Feel Good Breakfast show. I think you just...
Well done, Leanne. Well done.
Oh, it's so good. Thank you.
Get a taste of the smooth island life and win big with Tropika Island of Treasure Maldives. Buy a Tropika, follow the entry details on the pack, and you could win daily airtime prizes, Daniel Klein watches, American Tourista luggage for your next adventure, vouchers from loot.co.za to shop the hot daily deals online, and the grand prize of a Kia Picanto. For competition T's and C's, visit tropika.co.za. And don't forget to watch Tropika Island of Treasure Maldives every Monday at 7:30 p.m. on SABC3.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Expresso right here on SABC3. Now, this year we celebrate and honor the centenary of Nelson Mandela and Albertina Sisulu. And coming up this weekend, Durban is honoring two other iconic historical figures that have also made a powerful and lasting positive impact on the world. It is the 14th annual Salt March, and it pays tribute to Mahatma Gandhi and Albert Luthuli.
Now, Gandhi actually has historical ties to South Africa. He moved here as a young lawyer and ended up spending 21 years in our country. He was never planning to stay here for long, but in 1893, an incident occurred that changed his life and set him on a course to become an iconic activist of peace. He was boarding a train in Pietermaritzburg when a white man denied him entrance into the carriage, and because he was Indian. Now, after refusing to give up his first class ticket, he was thrown off the train.
Now, instead of accepting his fate, he decided to protest peacefully, and so emerged his unique version of non-violent resistance that eventually influenced the world. Now, the march also commemorates other iconic visionaries in the form of Albert Luthuli, who was the first black African to earn the Nobel Peace Prize in 1960. He was the leader of the ANC from 1952 until his death in 1967.
Now, the fact that these two great leaders held similar beliefs and promoted a culture of non-violence and Ubuntu is the message behind the Salt March. It's called the Salt March because it mimics a similar protest that was done 88 years ago in India against the taxation of salt and colonial oppression.
Wow, now the march is held annually and was started in Durban by Gandhi's granddaughter, Ella.
Mm-hmm. Now, if you are in Durban over the weekend, then make sure you get up bright and early on Sunday morning and join the Salt March. It kicks off at 8 a.m. at the Durban Amphitheatre in North Beach, and the march will proceed to go to Ushaka Marine World and then return to the amphitheatre. It's only 4.7 kilometres and it's not a race, so they encourage people of all ages to join the March of Peace and Ubuntu.
So, of course, a fantastic, I think, way to commemorate. So we certainly wish you well in that regard. But when we look at our sporting dramas currently unfolding at the moment, undoubtedly we're in the business end of the PSL, just three rounds left to play. We've seen a bit of a one-horse, maybe two-horse race at the top of the table, but Mamelodi Sundowns finding a key to success, both in cup, in continental and local league action. But when we look at the PSL in its whole, and I'm sitting with Mario Booysen and Siyanda Zwane, caught in, some would say, the relegation battle at the lower end, but they seem pretty confident of where this is going. But when we look at the PSL in general, it's been a very low scoring, it's been a tough season, it seems, for everyone, Mario.
I think it was a bit of an inconsistent season, for us. But for the whole league, it was like if you go on a three-game run, you in the top eight. So
yeah,
I think
coach of the month, yeah.
Yeah, you know. So I think it came down to who's more consistent at the end of the day, and I think that's Pirates and Sundowns was mostly consistent.
Yeah, man, and there is a fire there. Guys are wanting to score the goals, but we haven't seen a massive goal-scoring season. But it's difficult for you guys to now put that in perspective when it feels like you're playing good football, but the results aren't going your way. Is that something that you guys talk about in the locker room to kind of adjust that mindset? How do you get over playing well and not getting the results? I mean, you guys are rooted at the bottom of, or close to the bottom of the log. That's got to have a psychological effect.
Yeah, it is very frustrating, but we talk about such situations because in the game of football, some things like that, they do happen. Sometimes you play bad and then you get the results. Sometimes you play good and then don't get results. But as the Ajax Cape Town, we have to soldier on, you know, until the finishing line. And in the next three games, we just want to go all the way and win all these three games. And the sky's the limit. Anything can happen.
I'm guessing he's giving talks in the dressing room, mate. At halftime, I love that, man. But you've got to take it game by game. And, of course, your next hurdle, Baraka FC, coming up this week. You drew 2-2 with them. There are no weak teams left this season. Certainly the first half of the season proved that any team can dominate at any given moment. What are you expecting from this outfit second time around?
For me, I think Baraka is also fighting for points because they want to finish as high as possible. Most of the team is fighting for points to finish as high as possible. But I think we have the home advantage now. And yes, we know what they're about, but we have to stick to what we believe in and to our game plan. Because we've been playing good football for the past 3-4 games. And I think if we have to stick to that, we can come up with a positive result.
The Ajax faithful, they're with you guys. And this is something that I think very few teams get right. You get your glamour clubs up north, But Ajax Cape Town faithful, they'll be there, regardless of what stadium you're playing in, where the team is in form. How important is it for you to have this culture? Maybe you're facing tough times at the moment, but you're representing a proud brand.
Yeah, I think on Sunday, especially when we played Chipa, our fans drove up with the bus. They sit in the bus for 14 hours and they just got there before the game. So I think we have to also give them credit. You know, we have to do it for them. And also, you know, we have to do it for everyone at the club at the end of the day, because everyone is supporting us. And we have to get out of this position. We're not just the players is in it, but I think the whole club is in it with us. So yeah. I think we have to do it for the whole academy, the people that work in the office, you know, the coaching, the fans especially that travels a long way to come and support us, you know. But I think going into this game, I think that we'll get the support because we're at home and, you know, at Tottenham Stadium.
And you're all fighting. Fans are fighting. Players are fighting. I love it. You can give the bus speech. You can give the Changum speech, man. That was awesome. Mario, Siyanda, thank you so much for joining us. We're going to keep you around just a little bit longer to have a bit more fun. But that's our take on the relegation battle and where we stand in the PSL at the moment.
Well, thank you so much, G-Man. It's almost soup season, everybody. I'm so excited. And if you are dreading having to cook big, big pots of nutritious soup for your whole family this winter, then let me tell you, the NutriBullet RX might just be what you need. And here to introduce it to us and, of course, make a delicious cumin-scented carrot soup is none other than Zola Nene! That's my Zola Nene dance. Did you like it?
I did.
I love you.
So listen, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Here and already you're cooking. That's why we love you.
Hey, I'm here to do a job.
Getting in there. All right, so we're making a delicious cumin-scented carrot soup today.
Yes, we are. And we're using this amazing machine. So I'm very excited.
The NutriBullet RX, everybody. Yeah, now, this one is actually the most technically advanced of all of the NutriBullet family. Hey? Mm-hmm. So we're in there.
We're in. Okay, so let me tell you what I've done to prepare the vegetables. So you said it's a scented, cumin-scented carrot soup. So in here, we've roasted some carrots with some whole cumin, some onions, and a bit of chili flakes and salt and pepper. And you want to roast it, olive oil as well. Roast it at about 180 degrees for an hour, just so the carrots soften.
Of course.
And what I love about this is that you can do, this machine, is that you can do this in advance. And then it heats up the soup for you.
It does. I mean, it does. And we're going to show you how in a second.
Life changing.
And this one actually outperforms any of the other NutriBullets in that family because it breaks down the plant food and it's very easily digestible as well. Why do we roast it? I feel like roasting just gives it that certain
technical term.
Yes.
It intensifies the flavor of whatever you've roasted, so the carrots become even more carroty and more savory. Okay, so I'm going to put that in there while I roasted the carrots as well. Wrap a whole garlic bulb.
A whole one.
Okay. In some foil and then roast it alongside. And then once it softens, because the natural sugars in the garlic will caramelize as well and soften, you can see it's all squeegee. So then you just want to squeeze. And also
honey.
It's a milder. That's all goodness.
That is garlic
and
goodness, you
it's
guys.
It's garlic goodness, but it's a milder garlic goodness.
Yeah.
Okay, so just a little bit of that.
So if you're looking to impress somebody, make sure that they're eating this with you. Because, you know, garlic and garlic works together.
Right, you
but
need
garlic and
no don't garlic. Eat garlic by yourself, people. Yes. You'll ruin your life. Okay, so then some stock going in here. Because obviously it is soup, you need some liquid. And then for a bit of creaminess, but it's also lower in fat than cream, we use some coconut milk.
Zola, you are taking this to that next level.
So you just want to make sure that you don't pass that max line.
Yeah.
Okay. So my hands are dirty, so I'm going to let you do the honors.
Fantastic.
So first we blend.
Yes.
And then we heat.
Yes. First we blend and then just make sure that it's nice and secure. Okay, I just want to. Okay, cool. We don't want to have a situation.
No, we don't want a situation.
We can have a situation.
You all right?
That's fine. Okay, cool. So we're going to pop it on.
Yeah.
All right. And then I'm going to press this button and hold it in. So the key word this morning is bullet. What it's going to do now is it's actually heating up the soup as it's blending everything together. So you can pop this in, walk away, go and do a quick 7-minute workout or anything else that you can do in 7 minutes. I don't know. What can one do in 7 minutes?
Eat something else.
There we go. We can eat something else. And when we're done, of course, all you have to do is switch it off. But if you want to know how to make this recipe, all you have to do is check this out. The key word is bullet. 3, 3, 7, 2, 8. Check it out, everybody.
Wow.
Enjoy delicious and soothing soups this winter with a little help from the NutriBullet RX. To make a cumin-scented carrot soup, arrange roughly chopped carrots on a baking tray. Sprinkle over cumin seeds, chili flakes, seasoning, olive oil, and roughly chopped onions. Toss together. Wrap a whole garlic bulb in foil and add it to the vegetable tray. Roast the veggies in the oven at 180 degrees Celsius for an hour. Once cool to room temperature, transfer the veggies to the NutriBullet RX. Squeeze the roasted garlic out of their skins. Add the vegetable stock and coconut milk. Blend until smooth. Then press the G button for 2 seconds until it turns red to activate the 7-minute heating cycle. Once the soup is heated through, garnish with fresh coriander and crispy croutons and tuck in.
Indeed. As you can see, look at that beautiful steam there as the soup heats up. But we've already prepared one.
Yep.
Oh, and you've garnished it for us as well.
Garnished it a few croutons, a bit of herbage. What a cool machine to have for winter, right?
It's so cool. It's so easy. Yep. I love it. And it does all the work for you. That's the beautiful thing. That keyword, once again, bullet to 33728. We'll gladly send you the ingredients list and the recipe. And you could be making this yummy cumin-scented carrot soup
That's
yourself.
It.
And who knows, maybe Zola will just come and have dinner as well.
No?
Okay, let's taste.
Well, Joburg, it is your weekend to shine as the Presenter Search on 3 auditions are kicking off today at the Wanderers Stadium, and those gates open at 8 a.m. Today is auditions, tomorrow as well as Sunday. So make sure you come prepared with your 15-second link and you're ready to wow the judges. And of course, it's proudly brought to you by Mac Cafe and Capitec. Now, if you need to know more information, just head on over to our website. That's presentersearchon3.com. 5FM, they'll be broadcasting live, as well as some famous faces. They'll be looking to scout some talent. So make sure you bring your A game and don't miss out on any of the auditions taking place this weekend in Johannesburg.
So we're going to take the quickest of breaks. When we return, we're going to continue chatting to Zola about her brave new adventure with the Eat Out team, and then being quite possibly the worst football player on the face of the planet in the history of the game, we're going to use our Ajax stars to give myself and Zoe a little bit of a footballing skills lesson. Join us for that after the break.
It's my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back to You at Home. Welcome to you, Theunis Jansen van Rensburg. It's time for our tech daily update. What a crazy world we live in at the moment. Some amazing stories surfacing. And this one certainly got my attention because I was around for the original version of the Concorde.
Right.
That name has emerged yet again. What's the deal?
So we've been trying to get supersonic jets off the ground since the Concorde was grounded more than a decade ago. And it seems like we're finally heading in that direction again. So NASA has given over $270 million worth of funding to Lockheed Martin to build a new supersonic jet. And the first one is going to be a single-seater to test the technology and to overcome the struggles that Concorde had.
It was amazing how far ahead of their time the Concorde was, but of course rounding off in an absolute disaster with that world-famous crash. But hopefully they get it right. I absolutely love that. Then let's bring it a little closer to Earth. Elon Musk has been talking about the Hyperloop for some time. That could become a reality sooner than we think.
Yeah, finally. He's having quite a bit of trouble to get a working prototype to start testing with actual passengers. There was plans to...
No one's brave enough to test the Hyperloop that moves.
Well, it's all about regulation and the government, you know. So there were plans to have a Hyperloop between San Francisco and Los Angeles. That's been scrapped. But now the Middle East is coming to the rescue, and they're going to essentially build one next year already. Wow. To start running a short track between Abu Dhabi and Dubai. So it's not going to be the full distance yet, but that's going to be the first real Hyperloop that's going to be tested. And then hopefully they'll connect the two cities within a couple of years.
Yeah, I think from that it's going to be a short hop to see it into its final phase. Love that. Then I think all of us are dreaming in the back of our mind with all these new technological advancements that we can actually become superheroes. that there are going to be suits or tech that we could put on ourselves to actually do things like fly. It's here.
Well, not in itself, but it'll feel like you're flying. So basically, there's been a new suit that's been developed, meaning that you can use VR to fly a drone. So you move around like a bird sitting down, and you've got those little struts there on your arms to support your arms. But you basically, every single movement you make does control the drone. So from left to right, the yaw, the pitch, everything is kind of very accurate in terms of how the drone works. And this is kind of the first step. And with the VR goggles, you know, it's much more immersive than just using the remote like you usually do on a drone. So, this is an experience that's going to be here very soon.
I'm just sitting randomly.
Look, it looks a little weird, as most new tech do, but it's definitely going to make the art of flying drones a lot more, comprehensive for younger people to learn, and also, you know, just more immersive.
It's going to change the whole flight simulator thing. Did you say pitch and yaw?
Yes.
Oh, you see someone spent his time on a simulator there. Absolutely love it. Dude, thank you so much. Three incredible stories. This morning, you can let us know on our social media platforms and pages what you thought, which story has jumped out on a crazy week in the world of tech.
Oh man, it's so wonderful to have our amazing Zola Nene here. And of course, we all know that she's been a face and beloved by our Expresso show. And she made sure that she's been keeping us in the loop with everything that's been happening, from food trends to recipes to the best ways to incorporate these into our home-cooked meals or even our restaurant exploits. And if you were worrying that she may stop doing so now that she's moved on to bigger and brighter things, do not fear, because Zola always loves us and she'll always come back to our Expresso family. But she's also joined the very prestigious Eat Out team. So let us give a very big welcome and a big congratulations to Miss Zola Nene.
Yeah, I love coming here. You say my name and people cheer. It's like, it's the best.
We should just have Zola Day. I think so.
All
okay?
the time.
All day, time. Every day. So Zola, congratulations
on
this.
Thank you, my friend.
Gosh, just another amazing achievement, because you're just racking them up, honey, which is fantastic. But for those of us at home who don't know what Eat Out is all about, do you want to just contextualize for us?
So Eat Out is, in summary, the food authority when it comes to restaurants and chefs in the country. So they host the big award ceremony where they award the best chefs, the best restaurants, the best in terms of the food world.
Yeah. And what about the best restaurant visitors, like the people who love to
There's
eat the
There's not
best.
An award for that yet, but I can talk to them.
This is why you're here. This is why you're here, so that we can bring new categories
right?
into it. Okay, so what's your focus going to be in particular?
Okay, so I joined the team as the
restaurant editor for Cape Town for the publication. Yeah. So I write I review restaurants in Cape Town and I write about them for the online platform. Part of the new team who also joined with me is Colega Kumalo, who is the restaurant editor in Joburg.
Yeah.
And then Mocho Yansa, who you'll remember.
Wonderful. Yes.
From Le Cartier days. She is heading up the judging panel for the big award ceremony. So she is going to be sort of the communicator between the judges, who will still remain anonymous, as well as the restaurants and the chefs, etc.
So you're basically going to walk into a restaurant and everybody's going, guys, is here, guys.
No, never. What is really cool about this is that, like, I eat anyway. I mean, everyone knows that. But now I get to eat every day and call it my job. Like, I can actually say, no, I'm working. Every time you see me for lunch, I'm working.
You've arrived, friend. Working, this is levels. So you've been a reviewer for the last 2 years.
I have.
What are you hoping to bring to this new platform?
I think that inclusion and diversity is always something that we're always talking about, especially in the country that we live in. So it's great that there are new black faces on the panel, recognizable as well. So people, you know, young people, young black chefs who are up and coming can see somebody on an Eat Out platform and be like, oh, that person looks like me, which means that I actually could potentially end up there. And I think that that's always a good thing.
Well, we all know that Eat Out is like the premium kind of like, you know, food guide in South Africa. What does it mean to you to be a part of such an incredible platform?
I mean, it's a platform that I've respected for many, many years, even before they knew who I was and actually asked me to be part of the panel. So it's just like, it's such an honor for them to go, look, guys, we trust her enough to actually give her a position in this prestigious platform or brand and make her one of the team. And I think that being part of the Eat Out team is like goals.
I love it.
And it's a goal that I reach. Yeah. So I'm excited. I'm excited
to be part of the team. It is goals indeed. And you know what? We're so proud of you as we watch your journey just continue to, your star just continue to rise. And to know that you're still very much a part of our family makes it all the more special.
You can't get rid of me. You can't get rid of family.
And listen, if ever you need someone to go with you to one of these restaurants, I'm available. I'm just saying so right now.
Yeah, of course, you. Standing invitation.
Come on, you heard it here first, okay? So don't go anywhere, because if you want to see more of Zola, she's going to be tantalizing our taste buds throughout the morning.
Well, it's time for the fun and games to begin, because Lay's wants to give 5 lucky consumers the chance to hashtag Lay's Ukraine experience. And that is all. And that will also include double tickets to the UEFA Champions League final that's taking place at the end of May alongside myself and Kat. Now, when it comes to football and soccer, skills and tricks is really what will take that game from zero to victory. And of course, we are about to be put through our paces, and I'm a little nervous.
Do you know why I'm challenging you, Zoe? Because I don't think anyone deserves to go to you wait for Champions League final. I mean, come on, man. It's just rough, man. No, we are so happy for you. But of course, we've got Siyanda and Mario here from Ajax Cape Town. You guys are going to help us out this morning, all right? So you're going to give us, we're going to get 3 basic elements of football down right now. 2 of the worst football players that you've ever encountered, who have ever touched a football. You're going to have to coach us and then judge us. Okay, whoever does the better, you're going to put one of these little blue balls in our respective little baskets there. And at the end, the champion gets this beautiful bowl of Lay's, and then I take her place at the UEFA Champions League final next week. So the first thing we're going to do, guys, is dribble. Dribbling is vitally important, I would imagine.
I think dribbling is important for you, because dribbling teaches to get past players.
Okay.
You know, so I think
can you give us a brief little demonstration before
Zoe and I do it? Control.
Yes, so you just go.
He doesn't want to dirty his shoes. Sorry, man.
Gosh, and you're going a figure of 8 as well.
Wow.
Here we go.
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you feel you've got a vibe?
I'll give it a go. Okay.
Nice. You've got skills, girl.
Getting there.
Skillsy.
There we go.
What up? You're doing well.
Come back.
Oh, I don't get it.
Oh,
it's a goal. I don't know if that was the goal scoring challenge, but you've done it. Do you know what I'm liking the most, though? It's the robotic hands, the arms that go with it.
I'm keeping it here.
So you got to whoop.
See, Graham, you have to use your hands.
I think I have to give it to her.
Oopsie.
Oh, and we've lost a mic pack. So I'm going to ask you to be tough, man. Who's got that one? Your ball in your basket.
Can I just say, I only kicked 1 cone, although I did get into the goals, if that will help.
I tried for a little bit of flash, but... Go for it, dude.
I think I'm going for Zoe, because...
That's rough, bro.
No, because I think you...
It's rough, bro.
You kick two over, so I'll give it to
Fair game, fair game, fair game. Okay. I'm seeing something with the shoes, a bit of favoritism. Siyanda, you've got to place your judgment. Who gets the dribbling challenge this morning?
Okay, we're both getting
dribbled. Okay, should I take a ball and put it in this basket?
If you choose this me, is you yours? Put it
that's
in this
mine,
one.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll give it to
you. Oh, why did you even ask if you knew you were going to give it to her?
That's rough, man, that's rough.
No, fair game, Zay, that was very impressive.
Thank
well
you.
Done.
Thank so, you, thank you.
The next skill that is really important, especially when you look flash on the field, is juggling. Okay. Why is that important for a footballer to develop those skills?
I think it's important. Basically, you go through those phases in the development phase, but in the normal soccer game, you don't really have time to juggle the ball because there's so much pressure and a lot of tactics and what the coach expects from you. But I think growing up and you know, when you want to nurture your basics, and then you that's
where you gotta have that deft touch, man. So can you give us a little demonstration?
Okay.
Yeah.
Sometimes when you're starting, you can do like this with one foot. But when you grow up, then you're more confident on the ball. Then you're able to use both feet.
Oh, come on, man.
So it becomes easy.
Showing off now.
And when you were practicing earlier, you couldn't get it right once, and now the camera's on, you're like, boom, boom, boom. All right, so go for it, girl.
Can I use my hands now?
Okay, we're going to do it at the same time.
There we go, I lost my ball.
Yeah, you can just
check our camera. Check
your ball.
Yeah, you can use your hand and start like this.
Okay, so I'm allowed to touch it. There we go.
Oh, brilliant. Okay.
Okay.
Three.
Whoa, that was three. I mean, three is not that bad.
Last one.
Let's start again. Let me see. One. Two, three, four.
Graham's just
I thought we were in a team. Four is not bad. I'll put it in the bank, gentlemen. I'm hoping I'm going to come out more favorably with this judgment. Place your balls.
Yeah, I think it's pretty obvious where those balls are going.
I think I'm going to go with
I actually would have accepted it, man. I would have accepted it.
Well
come on.
Done, Graham.
Come on, come on.
I'll give it to you, man, this time.
Okay, this is
right. Okay, so our final challenger is goal scoring. This is where it comes down to the nitty-gritty. As you can see, we've got our massive goal post there. What's key when kicking for goal?
I think it's to look at the target first, get your mind to it, and then obviously the distance, it also determines, you know. So if it's close by, you can use the instep. If it's a bit further, you can use the laces. But this time it's a bit closer, so I think
we're going
the
instep.
Instep is better.
Oh, I'm so glad you didn't miss, man. I'm so glad you didn't miss. Okay, I love that. Zoe, do you think you're up to the challenge?
Yes, I'm up to the challenge.
No problem.
There we go. Let's hope it goes.
Can I try one step? No, you can do three tries if you want.
Let's try one.
Take your time.
Take your time. Relax.
Yeah.
Second time lucky. Okay.
I'm seeing some skills there. Can we deduct a point for touching the cone again? I think you moved the goalpost, so I'm actually trying to help me. I'll take it.
Away for Graham.
So you eye on the target.
Yes.
I can see it. I'm going to go with my instep because it's close. So what do we do? Do we call it a draw?
No,
you can do our final judgment. It's up to you.
You guys have to judge us.
Who's the overall winner of our footballing challenge this morning?
I'll give it to you because on your first time you put it in.
I struggled. That's only fair.
You know what? I'm going to make this interesting one. I'm going to give it a draw in it.
Okay. Oh, let's go.
It's going down to the wire.
Thank you so much, man.
You keep your seat at the UEFA Champions League final.
Hashtag life needs flavor, and Lay's has just the amount of flavor for you. Now, they're giving you the chance to win a hashtag Lay's Ukraine experience, plus double tickets to the UEFA Champions League final. And all you have to do is buy a UCL branded Lay's pack. You dial *120*76453# and you follow the prompts for one entry into the competition. And remember to keep your slip, and those T's and C's, they do apply with Lay's. And if you need more information, just visit Lay's South Africa's Facebook page. They've got all the details there.
Stand a chance to win a Ukraine experience plus double tickets to the UEFA Champions League final. To enter, buy, dial, and stand a chance to win.
Well, still to come on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, we're going to take a look at all of the movies coming up on SABC this weekend. Just in case you need to stay in and keep warm, we got you sorted. And then Liam Payne and J Balvin released their brand new single, Familiar. Guess what? We chat to Liam Payne after the break.
Oh.
Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Expresso right here on SABC3. Man, is it entertaining today. And we're going to keep up that entertainment with some international entertainment news. Zola, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, so this one is a little bit of a sad one because with all the news about the royal wedding dominating the media airwaves from Buckingham Palace, the world learned that the Queen was left heartbroken after the death of her last pedigree corgi named Willow, who was put to sleep at Windsor Castle on Sunday. Aww. Now, according to the Daily Mail, the dog had a cancer-related illness, and Her Majesty didn't want her much-loved pet, who was almost 15 years old, to suffer any longer. So the Queen's close association with the breed began more than 7 decades ago, and Willow was the last of the purebred corgis who were brought into the royal family by the Queen's father, King George, and was the last link that she had to her parents, according to Hello. So Willow has apparently been buried on Windsor Castle grounds. It's always sad to lose a doggy because they become part of the family.
That is sad. And the Queen, well, I think, was known to have said that her dogs are like her favorite thing in the world, and her horses.
Yeah. Even more than the grandchildren and everybody
Possibly.
Else. Oh,
Possibly.
Man. So we commiserate with you. Now, from the royals to South African royalty, none other than Trevor Noah, you guys. He's been living quite the life, from hanging out with Dave Chappelle to inspiring Oprah. Mm. And now casually sharing, you know, Twitter jokes with none other than Bill Gates. Yeah. I mean, come on. I mean, I saw this tweet. I was like, this is levels.
Levels.
I said at the same time. Now, the Daily Show host visited Josie in April and launched the Trevor Noah Foundation, which we know and applaud him for. It's absolutely amazing. The foundation is a non-profit organization that equips orphans and vulnerable youth with education, life skills, and social capital necessary to pursue further opportunities after finishing high school. At the launch, Noah said that it was his goal to start the program and better understand how to help schools move forward. Then, of course, we want to help these schools become more self-sufficient. Each experience will inform the next, he says. Today is only the beginning. Mm. So Bill Gates, who has said in the past that Noah is one of his favorite comedians, yes, came to his praise on Wednesday when he tweeted this. He says, "Congratulations, Trevor Noah, on the launch of your foundation. I can't wait to see what you accomplish next." I mean, come on. This is Bull.
Talk about a stamp of approval.
You know what I'm saying? Sure. I'm like, I just feel, I'm tired. I'm like exhausted. And then in response, the 34-year-old Noah said, "Thank you, Bull. You handle malaria, I'll figure out schools." I'm like, hey guys, seriously, you handle malaria and I'll figure out schools. But I think he's doing so well, and there's nothing, I believe, that Trevor Noah cannot do. But he's just a testament to the fact that you cannot let life circumstances, what has happened to you growing up, or your station in life, determine where you're going.
Yep.
And I hope that he continues to push that message and fly the flag high and inspire everybody to do the same.
Absolutely. What like a great you. Ambassador. For
you're a great ambassador too.
No, he is levels, like we said.
I just want to marry him.
Isn't he taken?
And the question remains. So we are friends yet again off the playing field now, getting back to the small screen. What's coming your way this weekend? Here on 3, we've got a stellar weekend of
movies.
That's
right. Well, we kick it off with SABC that's got a great movie lineup for you this weekend, starting with the movie Closer. It's a 2004 drama starring Natalie Portman, Jude Law, and Julia Roberts and Clive Owen.
Wow.
Now, the film is set in modern-day London and explores themes of passion, love, abandonment, and betrayal. And following four strangers and their chance meetings and instant attractions to one another, the film won several awards, including Best Supporting Actor and Actress by Clive Owen and Natalie Portman. So you know this is going to be a movie with brilliant and captivating performances. And that's taking place tonight at 9:30 p.m.
You came too. You focused on me. You said,
"Hello, stranger. What a floozy. Love is beautiful and caring.
You're wonderful.
Don't ever forget it.
But the same love can be so complicated.
You kissed me.
What are you, 12?
And bring us confusion, pain, and misery.
Why isn't love enough?
Did you ever love me?
Why are you doing this?
Clive Owen, Natalie Portman, Jude Law, and Julia Roberts. Closer, Friday at 9:30 on 3. The stage is yours.
Yo, and that soundtrack as well. Stellar cast. Then let's move to Saturday night, right here on 3. Two exciting movies lined up for you, starting with an absolute classic, Great Expectations, obviously based on the famous novel by Charles Dickens. So the film has an all-star cast: Helena Bonham Carter, Ralph Fiennes, Jeremy Irvine, and Robbie Coltrane. They tell the story, obviously, of the young, humble orphan who suddenly becomes a gentleman with the help of an unknown benefactor. Jeremy Irvine plays Pip, who is in his childhood version, and meets and falls in love with Estella, the adopted daughter of Mrs. Havisham, an eccentric and very wealthy spinster, that, of course, played by the brilliant Helena Bonham Carter, who then takes Pip on as a companion for herself and Estella. And the film follows Pip's life from childhood to adulthood, set in Kent and London in the early mid-19th century. Perfect Saturday evening film. It's a period piece that is brilliant. Some of the best literature and film that you'll see. Take a look.
She's very pretty. You can break his heart.
A story of wealth and poverty, love and rejection, and triumph of good over evil.
But you must know, Pip, I have no heart.
Oh, I don't believe it.
I've been made that way.
How can you do it, Estella?
What?
Give your affections to that man. And to give that man the looks and smiles you never give to me.
Do you want me to deceive you?
Do you deceive him?
All men but you. When you say you love me, I understand it as a form of words, but it touches nothing. Here.
No, it's not natural!
It is natural in me.
Great Expectations, Saturday at 7 on 3.
Now, following Great Expectations is the Thomas Crown Affair, an action-adventure drama with elements of mystery and suspense. And the film stars Rene Russo, Pierce Brosnan, and Faye Dunaway in a film about a self-made billionaire who can buy anything he wants and is irresistible to women, but still seems unsatisfied with life and finds himself involved in an art heist. Now, the film is a remake of the 1968 classic and is best hailed as one of the best remakes in cinema history, with critics praising the performances by Brosnan and Russo. Now, the original film had Faye Dunaway in the lead role, and the remake actually throws in a little treat by having her back as Thomas Crown's therapist. Now, it's a thrilling heist film with a solid love story and the perfect way to end off your Saturday.
You've yet to talk about women.
Oh, I enjoy women. A woman could trust me. As long as her interest didn't run too contrary to my own.
Good morning, Mr. Crown.
This painting worth $100 million.
A big heist.
They shut off the air to drive out the tourists.
Diversion.
Make a lot of noise over there. So over here in this room, you can take $100 million off the wall and waltz right out the front door.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, yes.
Leads to a cat and mouse game.
Do we know each other?
Not yet.
And whose head are you after?
Yours.
It's not about the money. You like the chase.
Rene Russo, Pierce Brosnan, The Thomas Crown Affair, Saturday at 9:30 on 3.
So now let's round it off with Sunday afternoon's feature here on SABC3, another brilliant Bollywood film for you to really sink your teeth into and wind down from the busy weekend. The Desi Boys are back in action in this adventure comedy. I think about two friends, roommates, Rebellious Jerry, you've got, and then Simple Nick, who live in London when they both find themselves out of work and struggling to keep their lives together. Jerry has a school-age nephew who needs to take care of, so obviously the pressure is on him, and he has to find a way to get his fiancée, Radhika, back into his life. And we've got some outstanding performances from some big names, Akshay Kumar and the brilliant John Abraham, who share a brilliant chemistry together on screen. And you really do believe that they've been friends for years, and it is hilarious. And the film actually is inspired by the aftermath of thousands of Indian students being duped by various universities in the West. So it's grounded in reality, but the humor really does drive it home. It's going to leave you feeling good and give you a bunch of laughs to round off what looks like a stellar weekend in movies right here on 3.
Yes, that's right. Well, listen, you do not want to miss out because yesterday we teased you about Liam Payne on the line with Leanne to chat about his brand new track that he's dropping today. And here's Leanne.
Wow.
Now, if you are a lover of Liam Payne from his One Direction days, straight through to him stripping that down on the bedroom floor where he gets it low, all for you. See what I did there? You won't be able to contain yourself with his brand new single he's releasing today, featuring Colombian reggaeton singer J Balvin, titled Familiar. He's joining us on the line all the way from London to talk to us about the release. Liam, welcome to Expresso. So good to be chatting to you.
I'm fantastic, thank you. How are you?
I am amazing. So it's safe to say that you are living your best life right now. I mean, the world's literally sitting on the edge of their seat waiting for your latest track with J Balvin dropping this Friday. How did that collaboration come about?
Well, we actually knew we had a mutual friend in New York who was I was going out for dinner with him and he kind of invited Jay along, so he just got into town. And we just got to talking, really, and found out that we're really good, we're really similar people, so we got on really well. And I was like, oh, cool, like, you want to have a listen to some stuff, so he had a listen. And he wanted to do something with the track, so I let him take it with him, and then he came back, and it's not, the thing I've been saying about this is it's not like he just did, like, the rapper verse on the track where it's just at the end of the song and someone does a rap. You know, he did the bits in the whole song, so it's a really together track, and I like that. I kept everything on it, and, yeah, here it is.
That's amazing. So you're hot right now, he's hot right now, but what was it like working together on this track?
It was amazing. You know, he's really easy to work with. He's a really, really lovely, wonderful guy. He's actually like Uncle Jay in my house now, since my son there. So, he's a little Colombian uncle, which is quite funny. I don't know. He's been really, really great. We had a good time doing the video and stuff. So, yeah, it's nice to make good friends around all the people that I've collaborated with so far.
Absolutely. And you've certainly collaborated with amazing people. I read in a recent interview that you said you met up with Pharrell in studio. Do you want to tell us more about what that was like?
Yeah, I met with Pharrell right at the start, actually, and it was a bit of the wrong time, but the right time at the same. You know, I was going through something because I was just becoming a solo artist, I was just becoming a dad. I know, I was just becoming a person, really, a man, and having the responsibilities to do, which is an interesting time in life. And, you know, he had a lot to say that really, I would say, the advice helped me through to, you know, being the person that I am now, as daft as it sounds, not to be cliche. But at the time, we didn't really know what to do with the music, so the studio session wasn't as great. But I think now that we're more on the same page, I think it will be a lot better. So I'm hoping to get back in with him again soon at some point.
That's amazing. Absolutely. Now, you have been releasing hit after hit. Congratulations, by the way, on getting a platinum and gold for you and for Strip That Down. But is there an album
in the
near future?
Yeah, the album's literally just about to come out. I've got it I've had it on hold for a little bit, and you know, it's kind of turned out of this little magical playlist of different people because I've been so accepted by, you know, all my peers and colleagues and people that are in the industry that I've managed to get so many collaborations together. And I think that's great because in today's world, you know, it's all about the collaborations and the different, you know, different sounds on a playlist, and that's kind of how my album's turned out. So I'm extremely grateful that, you know, all these brilliant people wanted to work with me at their peak.
That's incredible. Now, Liam, I know that you've been traveling for a while. You're performing all over the world, from Japan to Germany, the UK, the US. But you also mentioned being a dad. How do you manage to kind of keep your schedule, intact so you can also balance it all and spend time with the family?
Yeah, I mean, I've got a great team who sort all that out for me and make sure that I don't spend too much time away because I think it's really important. But you have to understand that, you know, I think it's really important that I do this right now as well because, you know, if I was just to sit on my success in One Direction and stay at home with my son, and I'd love to spend every minute with him, but at the same time, you know, I have to work hard. If I'm not working hard, you know, what am I teaching my son at that point, really, that you can just sit around in your laurels because you had a good time? Like, I don't think that's wise. So for me, it's like just as important as being at home with my son and spending time with him is also being out and trying to make something of yourself so that when he grows up, I can tell you, see, this is what I was doing when you were growing up because I wanted to give you this and also teach you this. You know, I think that's the best thing I can do right now.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree with you more. Now, it's all over the socials. You made a cheeky comment about a certain reunion of One Direction. Is that true? Can we expect a reunion in the future?
You can definitely expect a reunion in the future. It's definitely true, except for the fact that when I said we've all spoken about it, I meant in interviews, every one of the boys has mentioned that every one of the boys has mentioned that there's going to be a reunion. So obviously if everyone's talking about it, it's going to happen. We haven't actually spoken together, although I did speak to Louis today briefly this morning on FaceTime. It was really lovely to speak to him, actually. And, yeah, everything's good in the life one day at the minute. I think everyone's really enjoying the freedom of this, you know, solo venture.
Fantastic. Well, the solo venture is going really, really well. Keep doing it. You're doing absolutely amazing.
Thank you.
And do you think there's a possible visit to your fans in South Africa and in Cape Town, all over the country, anytime soon?
I definitely do. I mean, I'm desperate to travel the world and start singing again like I used to. You know, I've done a couple of gigs recently that have been really, really great, and they've really spurred me on for this, so I've got to make sure I get it right. But hopefully, you know, end of the year, next year, I'll be able to announce some sort of tour or something that I can come around and see everybody and play for all these great people.
Well, we'll be holding thumbs. Liam, thank you so much for chatting to us. You're doing so amazing, and we can't wait for that release coming out today. It's going to be incredible.
Thank you very much. You have a nice day now.
Ciao, ciao. Oh, if you are as excited as we are about the release of Familiar by Liam Payne and J Balvin, then head over to Spotify and preload the track for a chance to be one of the first to hear it.
Wow, what a scoop. Well done, Lily. We're going to take a quick break while you go and download that and check out the tune online. And we're going to give you an opportunity to gather your thoughts before another mind-blowing performance. The Lady Day Big Band are in the house, and they're going to be bringing those cool vibrations just like our princess. Then we're going to hop back into the kitchen to whip up some spicy chicken and rice. Sounds delicious. Don't stray too far. Expresso, thank you so much for tuning in this morning. The Lady Day Big Band about to give us a brilliant performance. But first, let's quickly run you through those news headlines.
In the national news this morning, President Cyril Ramaphosa has cut short his visit to the UK to meet with ANC leaders over the ongoing violence and chaos that has erupted in Mahikeng in Northwest Province. He will address an urgent meeting convened with structures of the ruling party in the provincial capital later today. The president was leading a South African delegation to the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting in London. Ramaphosa says that he has noted with serious concerns reports of clashes between protesters and the police this week. Transport Minister Blade Nzimande yesterday appealed to all parties concerned to urgently find a negotiated settlement as the countrywide bus strike drags on. Thousands of commuters were again left stranded yesterday as dozens of bus companies across the country are affected by the strike. Taxi operators have been trying to accommodate the additional commuters as bus drivers have vowed to continue with the strike until their wage demands are met. They want a 12% wage increase while the employers are offering 7%. Now moving further abroad, in Cuba, Communist Party stalwart Miguel Diaz-Canel, who is said to be a Richard Gere look-alike, replaced Raul Castro as president yesterday, starting a new chapter for the island after nearly 60 years of rule by the Castro brothers.
Díaz-Canel was sworn in by the National Assembly with 603 of the 604 lawmakers present voting for the 57-year-old. The transition is not expected to herald sweeping changes to the island's state-run economy and one-party system, one of the last in the world. And then finally, the King of Swaziland, one of the world's few absolute monarchs, announced yesterday that his country had changed its name to Eswatini to mark 50 years since independence from British rule. Meaning place of the Swazi, Eswatini is the Swazi language name for the tiny nation landlocked between South Africa and Mozambique. King Mswati III declared the name change during Independence Day celebrations at a packed sports stadium in the second city of Manzini. Well, that was your 8 o'clock news update. Here's another look at what's happening in the world of sport with Graham.
Let's kick it off with football. Plenty of cup action coming your way this weekend. Starting here in South Africa, the final two teams in this season's Nedbank Cup will be decided this weekend. As semi-finals fixtures, they'll be taking place across the country. First up, Kaizer Chiefs face off with Free State Stars just 2 weeks after the teams met in the league, of course, where Amakhosi secured that 1-0 win thanks to a goal in the final minutes of the game. The other semi-final matchup sees Mamelodi Sundowns, our runaway log leaders in the PSL, up against Giant Slayers Maritzburg United on Sunday. Then staying with the beautiful game, Chelsea's quest for Champions League football next season still on course following their 2-1 win over Burnley last night. That result takes fifth place Chelsea to 63 points on the table, just 5 adrift of fourth place Spurs with 4 games still yet to play this season. And of course, Chelsea in action again this weekend as they battle Southampton in the FA Cup semi-finals, while Manchester United will have to face off against fourth place Tottenham Hotspur. Then on to rugby, the Lions and the Waratahs kick off week 10 of Super Rugby a little bit later this morning with a clash in Sydney. Waratahs holding their 3-2 win record over the Lions in their last 5 meetings. However, the South African outfit pulling off a very memorable 55-36 victory when the teams last met. Also in Super Rugby action this weekend, the Bulls are up against the Rebels, while the standout feature locally, the Stormers and Sharks, clash in a local coastal derby. And then finally, on to tennis. Novak Djokovic's journey back to form hit yet another hurdle yesterday as he suffered a shock round of 16 loss to Dominic Thiem. That, of course, at the Monte Carlo Masters. Djokovic took the early advantage with a 7-6 win in the first set before Thiem battled back to see out the match with a 6-2, 6-3 win in the final two sets. And some other results coming out of the day's play, Rafa Nadal, Grigor Dimitrov and Alexander Zverev all moving through to the last eight. And that's a wrap of your sport for this Friday morning.
Well, let's take one final look at the road, starting off in Gauteng in Bedford View. Just a quick reminder to please avoid the N3 northbound. There's been a multi-vehicle accident and it's causing severe delays between Reading Interchange all the way to northbound towards Modderfontein Road. And in the Western Cape and Kells River, there's also been an accident on the R300 highway and it's causing congestion between Hindle Road and Van Riebeek Road, so allow for some extra travel time. And that's where we leave your traffic on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Cirrus Water, the future of sustainable water.
On that note, let's take one final look at what to expect in terms of your weather for today. Polokwane starting off on a low of 14, reaching a high of 23. Cloudy conditions in Mbombela 16, 23. Pretoria 13, 24. Johannesburg 12, 22. Mahikeng 10 with a high of 27. Partly cloudy conditions in Klerksdorp, 8 your minimum, 27 your maximum. Kimberley 8, 24. Bloemfontein 6, 22. Some rain expected in Richards Bay, a low of 14, a high of 23. Pietermaritzburg 14, reaching a high of 20. Durban 20, 23. Mthatha 10 with a high of 20. East London partly cloudy, a low of 14, a high of 22. Craddock 7, 24. Port Elizabeth 13 with a high of 21. George starting off on 10, reaching a high of 20. Sutherland 4 with a maximum of 20. Partly cloudy conditions in Cape Town today, a low of 10, a high of 20. Worcester 7, 24. Springbok 8 with a high of 25. And Upington 11 with a high of 25 degrees Celsius. And that's where we leave your weather on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Happy birthday, a very happy birthday to you.
A very happy birthday to you indeed. Now, every day, millions of people celebrate their birthdays all over the world. So as we welcome today, the 20th of April, let's take a moment to wish some of our celebs and you a very happy birthday.
Now, Zara, I don't know if you know this, but veteran actress Jessica Lange celebrates her birthday today, and she burst onto the screen in 1976 when she starred in King Kong and won herself her very first Golden Globe for her performance, and of course the adventure classic. Since then, she's received several awards, including two Academy Awards for Tootsie and Blue Sky. She also went on to win a Tony Award, three Emmy Awards, four more Golden Globes Awards, thus securing her the place in the very coveted EGOT Club, Winners Club. So very, very nice.
Congratulations on your birthday, or happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
And also celebrating her birthday today is Australian model Miranda Kerr, who turns 35 today. Now, she was the first Australian model to be part of the Victoria's Secret Angels squad in 2007. And did you know that she's married to CEO of Snapchat, Evan Spiegel, and they're expecting their first, which is her second child, together.
Very, very nice. We also want to wish one of our favorites here on Expresso, Miss Cosmo from 5FM, and of course, Rhea Wilson, who turns 61 today. So, Miss Cosmo, hoping you have an amazing birthday, and Rhea, happy birthday to you too.
Well, that was our bite-sized dose of birthdays, and remember, you can share your birthday with us or wish your loved ones by tweeting us at Expresso Show.
So we are privileged this morning to have some truly talented and phenomenal female artists who make up the Lady Day Big Band experience. And it is an experience that you have to experience for yourself. So we're going to give you a taste right now. Finally, I demanded it earlier, didn't get it. Now I'm going to get it. It don't mean a thing. Thank you so much for that. That was really, really awesome.
Thank you.
You're just living your best life.
Oh my God, I'm wearing my sequins. I got my curls out. Got a big band.
You're sounding amazing. I'm so glad you said you got the big band. What is it about a big band having this kind of collective, collaborative effort behind you as a performer? Why is a big band so awesome and so different?
Because you've got 17 people behind you playing live instruments, and it's just all this energy and power. And for someone like me who's got a massive voice, so most of the time I have to like contain it and hold my ear. But with a collective like this, I'm just like, ah. So it's, for me personally, I love Yes, I'm like, wow, I'm alive.
It's fine. My so 1-year-old baby is also does the
right.
I absolutely love that. No, it's, I can see how much it means to you. How much, on a personal level, does it mean to you to have these ladies with you doing this?
I'm not going to cry. But it's just incredible. For me personally, I'm an advocate for more women in the music industry. And also just representation. So seeing, I really hope that someone out there, a little kid, sees this and is like, oh my gosh, I want to play the guitar. Oh my gosh, I want to play the trumpet. Because music and instruments is not just for boys, guys. Women can do it too.
And do it better, yo. And do it better.
He said it. He said it.
That was just very special.
Thank you so much.
It really
us.
Has elevated our Friday morning. You can let us know what you thought of both of those performances
and like
this
our
morning.
Page.
Please go onto Facebook, show them some love. We're going to take the quickest of breaks. We'll see you on the other side. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
Step into the spotlight as South Africa's next TV superstar with Presenter Search on 3, proudly brought to you by Capitec and McCafe.
Own the SABC 3 stage as the newest host of Top Billing, Afternoon Express or the Expresso Morning Show.
This is your last chance to be found on 3 at the Johannesburg auditions taking place on the 20th, 21st and 22nd of April at the Wanderers Cricket Stadium.
Visit presentersearchon3.com for more details.
With SABC 3,
the stage is yours.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show, the Friday edition, and the next edition of the KAMERS Makers Markets will once again bring the finest handcrafted wares displaying exceptional craftsmanship for admirers to marvel and buy. And this time it's at the St. David's Maris in Nanda in Sandton from the 25th till the 29th of April. And joining us to give us a taste of what to expect are the project managers of KAMERS Makers. It's Helene Rousseau, along with two of the makers who will be visiting Melissa Diedricks, owner of the Kali Leather Apparel, and Andile Mdakane, the founder of MAG Urban African Accessories. Ladies, good morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
Guys, I hope you guys are excited as I am for KAMERS Makers. And Helene, I'm going to ask you the first question. Why was it so important for you to create this platform, and how is Mzanzi Makers NGO also fit into this year's project?
No, of course, you know, there's lots of people making beautiful things in South Africa. There's such a lot of creativity, and we just realized that's how KAMERS started 16 years ago, and we have to give them this platform, because it's easy to create things, but how do you get it out there to the public to see them? So that's what we do. Yeah. And then obviously with Mzanzi, we just went a step further and we've gone into the community and we've linked with people and we've trained them certain skills which will also be available at the show, and we've also some other programs we've linked with, and we've got their products also showcasing at the show.
That's absolutely amazing. Now, yeah. Melissa, your brand Kali, it started out of frustration where you couldn't find, you know, good quality shoes for people that are petite. Now, for you, you know, how has making your own product transformed things for you?
Yeah, I mean, it's transformed
things a lot. If you've ever tried, or anyone out there's tried to shop for size 2 shoes in the adult section, you'd understand my frustration.
Yeah.
And I'm a firm believer that if you have a problem, you solve it.
Okay.
And that was the inspiration behind Carly and the inspiration behind the business. And then in terms of the quality aspect, that's a big portion of what Carly stands for. So from a product perspective as well as a service perspective. And as an example, our Oxford, which will launch next week at KAMERS Joburg, takes our shoemaker a full day to make one pair.
Sure.
And I personally check every single pair of shoes before it goes out. And if it's not good, we redo it and we don't sell it. And we have lots of lucky friends and family who get the tainted pairs for a discounted price because we don't waste as well. So yeah, it really has changed the way I shop.
Yeah.
Because it really was a real problem. And it's been nice to meet lots of other people actually with the same petite-sized feet problems, and it's been nice to fill that gap. So yeah, petite-sized ladies, there's hope.
There is hope indeed, and that's what's wonderful about this, because we discover all these hidden talents and these beautiful products. And Andile, I mean, we're looking at your accessories. They come in different shapes and they have different meanings, and you've also covered them in, is it Isi Sweshwe?
Yes.
Yes. Sweshwe. Why have you decided to cover it in Sweshwe?
So basically all the Meg accessories designs are based on ancient African symbols.
Mm-hmm.
So each single shape is a symbol that was used many years ago, and the whole concept was to bring back the symbols to life in a way that is not cumbersome, such as researching, but if you're wearing a symbol, then that's one way of knowing about it. And it was important to cover it in Isishweshwe because of the story, my story, my grandmother's story, my village's story, and everyone, you know, dressed up in different colors, Sweshwe pride. And so that's why it was important for me to cover them in Isishweshwe. And I also use perspex, which is very light, because I was also resolving my own issue of loving big earrings, but them being too heavy, like after an hour, I would have to remove them. So I use perspex, and it's super light, super light.
Well, yeah. I love it, and I'm seeing you wearing the accessories, so
yes.
It looks amazing. Well, ladies, thank you so much for joining us. Yeah. And we will have more with KAMERS Makers a little bit later. But if you want to catch all of the amazing, you know, handcrafted, passionately made, proudly South African products, do not miss out. It's taking place next week. That's the 25th to the 29th of April. It's at the St. David's Maris Inanda, that's in Sandton. And pre-sold tickets are available for 60 Rand, and 90 Rand can get you in at the gates. But for more information, head on over to kamers.co.za for more information.
So maybe you've been wondering what that sizzling in the background is. It is our beautiful shakin, a winner, winner, chicken dinner. We can't have our gorgeous Zulu princess, Mazozo, in the house without getting her to do a full menu of recipes today. So we've got a beautiful soup that's now chilling.
Yeah.
We're going to move on to the main course.
We are.
Chicken is always going to be going in for the win. It's the weekend. We want a nice hearty meal. It's a bit cold down here. We're moving into a new season. What do you got? This looks like a bit of heat. Hey,
it is. It's a bit of spicy chicken and rice.
Ooh.
And what I love most about this dish is you can make it all in one pot.
Beautiful.
I know,
which you're doing right now. So
which
take us
I am doing.
Okay. The ingredients first and then...
Yes, so what I've done to this chicken is I've browned it already, but before browning it, I dusted it in some cumin, ground cumin and ground coriander and a bit of cayenne pepper. So we're starting off the spice.
Wow.
Okay, so brown that. Take the chicken out, set it aside. Then to the exact same pot with all those delicious flavors in the bottom, add some onion. And then if you've got extra leftover spice, so the measure of the spice is still the same, okay? So all that goes in there, so don't waste it.
More flavor,
and then even more spice,
I
won't put all of it.
I was gonna say.
Because you look afraid already.
I love it, but I'm one of those poor people that I look at chili and my head starts perspiring.
Okay, no, I'm not gonna add.
I do love it, and this is what you want, to hearty. What I love here is how you've caramelized the skin on the chicken already.
I mean, how delicious.
So you're not gonna skimp on that flavor. There's one thing, cooking it in the pot, you don't wanna sacrifice the most delicious flavor in the world, which is chicken skin.
Well, true. I like a bit of chicken skin myself. But because this isn't going to sort of brown in the oven, I take the skin off.
And eat it straight.
Well, you can do that if you want. But take it off and then you don't have to worry about it. But yeah, skin is delicious.
It,
love it.
Absolutely love it.
So some chopped garlic, lots of chopped garlic.
Yeah.
And like Lee said, make sure that you share this.
Yeah, eat it with your dates, so, you know, whoever. You might have guessed that the keyword here is chicken to 33728 if you'd like a more concise breakdown of the recipe itself. to get you on your way. So now our wet ingredients go in.
Yep, so that's just some tinned tomatoes, and where there's tinned tomatoes, I always add a little bit of sugar.
Now I do as well.
Yeah, just so, you know, to offset that acidity. Let me try my English this morning, okay. Bit of salt and a bit of pepper. And then I use basmati rice. Not only is it flavorful, because it's quite fragrant, but it also cooks a little bit faster, because the grain's longer. So
boom,
pop that in there.
In the pot, any boiling nothing.
Nope, just as it is, because listen, this is a one pot wonder, so we don't want to
suck in all of those juices.
It's gonna absorb all those juices, absolutely. And then you want some water, of course, because the rice does need liquid to cook.
There we go.
So I usually do one pot rice to three pots liquid, but don't forget that the tomatoes also are liquid.
And that's gonna break down.
Okay, so then you wanna put this back in here.
Okay, so we're doing the chicken skins for me, but you can take the skins off if you don't want them to become soggy. And you've still at least cooked in the beautiful flavors.
Exactly. So this chicken is just brown, so you can see it's still quite raw.
So how long does it need to cook in there? Because we know chicken is a precarious situation.
Yeah,
you know, that you want to be careful when you're cooking chicken, especially.
You do, absolutely. So this will cook for about 45 minutes now, so you'll be guaranteed that the chicken is cooked. Also, I use chicken thighs, brown meat, so you can cook it for longer. It's more forgiving, it's juicier when it comes out.
It's going to break down nicely, and there's more flavor in there as well because it's on the bone.
Exactly. So, okay, so then we do a switcheroo. And once it's cooked, it looks just like this. So you can see the rice is lovely and fluffy.
Yeah.
Let me just move this chicken out the way. Can you see the rice?
Oh,
so
and it's absorbed.
So pass me a plate so I can dish you up some.
Please.
And then you can see, look, fluffy rice, all made in one pot. I mean,
no one has
an excuse to not cook during the week. Actually, it is Friday, so
you
don't really have any excuse. You got the weekend coming. So you dish up the rice first, just at the bottom here. Can you see? There's a bit of crusty bit.
But I love that. The flavor is all working.
That's what you and I will eat together forever.
You know what I'm saying.
Forevermore. And
that's my wish for today, that we sit and eat together. Thank you so much, dear. As we wrap up the final prep there, again, that keyword is chicken to 33728. You can be making your beautiful spicy chicken at home. You're a superstar.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Mm.
Well, listen, things are heating up in the Maldives as Tropika Island of Treasure Season 8 is well underway. There are only three teams left, and if you missed Monday's episode, there is a repeat taking place tomorrow on SABC 3 at 3 p.m. And I mean, we have Team Red, Team Yellow, and of course the real Cinderella team, Team White, still in the competition. So a lot of excitement. Make sure you catch that recap. But we're about to play a little bit of a game.
Exactly. And of course, there's massive prizes that you can win. If you go to get your Tropika bottle, look at the back. All of the details are on there. I mean, you could win loot.co.za prizes, tons of amazing things, American Tourister luggage, and then that grand prize of the Kia Picanto. But let's go, because we have none other than Miss Lana Crowster here. Of course, she's representing the ladies. Lady Day Big Band, the very first female big band in the country, am I right?
That's good.
I love it, because sisters are doing it for themselves.
Yes, girl.
Okay, so Lana, the rules of the game are such, you can only use one hand to hold that tray with your Tropikas.
Okay.
Then you gotta go as low as you can possibly go. Are you ready?
Okay.
While maintaining your balance. So something as well, the minute the Tropikas fall on the floor, that's when the game's over.
Oh, okay.
Yes. So
it's
if it falls over on your tray, just maintain the balance.
Yes.
Okay, a quick game. All right, in 3, 2, 1,
let's
go. How low can you go?
Woo.
How low can you go? Nice, Lana.
Doing very well, honey.
That back action, that squat action.
Oh, look at you.
That. She's got it going
on. Amazing.
I'm not even concerned about this.
There we go.
Nice.
I'm worried about the hair.
Don't worry.
The hair might be a problem.
There we go.
Oh, we love it. Nice.
There we go.
This is basically your gym session, Lana. You don't
basically
have to do gym today. There we go. Ooh, she's got it going on.
There we go. Well done.
That was a very sexy one that you just did there.
That one was for all the boys in Cape Town.
There we go. If you guys have just joined us, this is Lana Crowster, and she's playing our game, How Low Can You Go?
I always go impressive. People can go so low. There we go.
But Lana, you're also really tiny, so this might be working in your favor.
Don't drop the Tropika.
Nearly there, nearly. Okay, nice. Getting
done.
This is how we do it in the club.
This is how we do it in the club.
Those ones for Club Galaxy.
There
Lana
we go.
Lana got low.
I
love it. Do you think we can do one more, Lana?
Oh my God.
Do you think so? Okay, if you make this, you have got it. Okay, take your time.
Mission accomplished.
Think about it.
Where's the ladies to come and support you?
They've all got day jobs, though.
Go, Lana.
Let's see.
You've got this.
Half of it is done. Now the tough part of getting the rest of your body. There we go. Yes. Look at her.
She's nearly there. She's nearly there.
Lana,
nearly
you're a
there.
Machine.
Nearly there. Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, Lana Crowster has just proven how low she can go.
I
can I help you out, darling?
Oh, no. Thank you.
Oh, well done. You
there
got
we
this.
Go.
Amazing
oh,
stuff.
Awesome. I can't high five you, but there we go.
This is how low she can go. Of course, you can get all of the competition details on the back of the bottle and win some amazing prizes and that grand prize of a Kia Picanto. Nice.
Oh, Lana's never coming back onto the show ever again. Oh, man, awesome stuff. So she's proven her mettle here on the live show. It's opportunity now for you at home to prove your mettle. Joburg, your time has come. The presenter search on three auditions have officially kicked off. The queues have been standing there for ages. The gates opened at 8 a.m. this morning at the Wanderers Stadium in Johannesburg. Auditions, of course, are going to be running throughout today, tomorrow and Sunday. So you've got ample opportunity to go and show us what you've got. There are no excuses. Get down there. What you have to do is register at the gates, easy as that, and obviously have your 15, 30-second long link prepared and then go and wow the judges. Joburg is notorious producing some of the best talent, so make sure that you bring your A-game. The judges are going to be quite stiff, and we know that 5FM are there broadcasting live from the auditions, and I think there's an opportunity there to fast track your progress, so make sure you connect with them as well. We're going to see some amazing famous faces, part of our judging talent that are going to be out there scouting. So this is your opportunity, guys. Put your hand up. It's your time to shine. Really it is. And you can get all of the details and what you can expect at Presenter Search on 3 on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram as well. Go out there and shine, guys. We're going to take a very quick ad break. We'll see you now.
Next week on Tropika Island of Treasure Maldives, go!
It's the final elimination and we have one objective, that's to win the challenge.
Do it, boy! The contestants must battle the elements and each other in this season's final elimination.
I'm feeling very nervous right now.
My hands are shaking and the wind keeps blowing things off.
We could be out of elimination for the first time ever.
Catch Tropika Island of Treasure Maldives Mondays at 7:30 p.m. on SABC3. The stage is yours.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show. I hope you've refilled those coffee cups. Now, earlier we saw some of the exquisite handmade crafts that will be up for show and for sale next week at KAMERS Makers Market, taking place the 25th to the 29th of April at the St. David's Merits in Nanda, and that's in Sandton. Now, right now, we're jumping into a demo presented by Louisa Rademan, co-founder and product developer of Oleaf Natural Products, which makes natural body products that do not harm your skin or the environment. Louisa, great to have you on Expresso.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Well, let's talk about Olif Natural Products. I mean, where did this baby start, like this project start for you?
Well, Olif started about 7 years ago, and it was literally a gift of love. My sister had her first baby, and I made her a gift, which was the bum cream.
Okay.
And it was literally just, I went to the kitchen cupboard. I've always been exploring and experimenting with products, and I made her a gift. And then from there on, we've realized that she really enjoys the product, her friends and family, and other mothers also enjoy the product, and then Olif started.
That's amazing. Yeah. And how do you manage to keep your products 100% natural?
It is quite a challenge. We are certified by the Soil Association, which is a COSMOS standard. It's a European regulating body, and they check all our raw ingredients for us, and we make sure that we source 100% certified natural organic products from farmers. So we spend a lot of time actually sourcing raw ingredients and making sure that the product is pure and good for you.
That's amazing. Yeah. What are some of the product types that you offer? Because you mentioned that there's something for baby. Who else can use the product?
Yeah, so we've actually got three ranges, which is quite nice. We've got the baby range specifically for babies, and then an adult range to treat yourself. We started with the baby range, but then the moms and the sisters and the aunts started asking for products for themselves. And then after the adult range, we did the 100% natural sun care range, which was one of the very first in South Africa where it doesn't have any chemical filters. So it's a pure natural base. So we've got three very nice ranges.
That's very exciting. So you will be doing a few demos at KAMERS Makers. Are you going to show us a little something of what to expect next week?
Yes, so at KAMERS, we started an exclusive range at KAMERS, which is our DIY range. You can come to the Olif stand and you can make your own body scrub, you can make your own body oil. We present you with the good organic ingredients and you choose and you mix and you make and you personalize it. So you choose your scent, you choose the oils that you like.
Okay.
And we basically stand there and prepare your product for you.
And guide you through it.
Yes.
So let's see, what did you bring along? Are you able to quickly put together for us?
I've chosen some of my favorite oils.
Yeah.
I've chosen organic apricot kernel oil, olive oil, which is the Olif's favorite oil. That's where our name comes from. I've got avocado pear oil. And then I chose three essential oils, which is Roman chamomile, rose geranium and clary sage, which is very nice soothing and balancing oils. And then basically what you do is I'll just mix them together. You choose the ratios of the oils you want. You can always research which properties of the oil you want more in your body oil. And you basically just blend the oils together.
Here we go.
And then the scent is quite the fun part, because that basically, even though the oil has got all the nutrition, the scent's also got aromatherapy properties, but that gives that special personal scent to the product.
Yes.
And then you just basically, you always just add a few drops because they're in a concentrate.
Yeah.
And your carrier oil will be your more heavier base.
Less
product.
Is definitely more in this case.
Yeah, so then you basically just make sure it's all blended and mixed up. And then you pour it into any container. Either you can come to KAMERS and we specially make it for you, or at home you can recycle any jar that you've got. You pour the oil in, and then you've got like a very nice oil.
Yes. Oh, amazing. I'm going to try some. There we go. And Louisa, you will be doing these demonstrations at KAMERS. Thank you so much for joining us and showing us. Oh, my word, it smells amazing. Okay, I'm going to keep this on my hands. And make sure you do not miss out on the country's biggest celebration of handcrafted, passionately made, proudly South African products. It's taking place next week from the 25th to the 29th of April at the St. David's Maritz Inanda, that's in Sandton. Now, pre-sold tickets are available for 60 Rand, and 90 Rand gets you in at the door. But head on over to the website kamers.co.za for more information.
Now this week on Top Billing, Jeannie D is living her best life as she continues her travels in Canada. And then Lorna gets to go behind the scenes of a skin tone underwear photo shoot. You can catch all this and more in the new time slot. This is Top Billing every Saturday at 6 p.m. Or if you miss it, you can catch the repeat on Sunday at 12 midday.
Get your Saturday party started on hashtag Top Billing as women from SA to New York celebrate Gugu Ngabinde's stunning new brand of skin tone underwear.
Ladies, now you and I both know how difficult it can be to find well-fitted underwear. Well, Gugu Ngabinde, CEO of Gugu Intimates, has found the solution. Let's go meet her.
Ayanda and food blogger Tuli Gogela try a restaurant devoted to the art of roasting.
There's a new check in town brought to you by the founders of HQ Restaurant. Roast & Co. is challenging long-winded menus by focusing on one thing and one thing only that they're really good at, and that is chicken.
Jeannie meets a Canadian forestry pilot who seeds trees by helicopter and shows us a secret mountain world very few have glimpsed.
Oh my goodness! This is incredible!
Does the novelty of your job ever wear off?
Never, never, never gets old. I absolutely love it.
Youngest ever world number one, Martina Hingis, wants to encourage a Wimbledon tennis champion from Africa.
We know you've played against several South Africans on the court, but have you ever been to our country in a personal capacity?
No, it's my first visit to South Africa, and I'm very pleased to be part of this wonderful charity. You know, it's a great cause and I'm always up for it.
Interiors architect Rene Duval opens this home to a sweeping seascape and one-of-a-kind design.
You had a blank canvas to work with because it was an old rundown house. No one was living here.
The client absolutely has a love relationship with the ocean, so we try to open up the areas as much as possible and also to integrate your various sections so that it felt more than open space.
Whether you love to be beside the seaside or on top of the world looking down.
That's Top Billing this Saturday, 6 p.m. on SABC3. The stage is yours.
And now, dessert. Zola Nene. You bring the sweetest things with you. That's and right. I mean that literally, not just your demeanor, but these little pillowy cases of joy and goodness. We are making some cinnamon donuts filled with custard.
We are.
We've got our Clover classic custard here, the star of the show. But this looks awesome and a little bit involved, I won't lie. So
not
what's
too
the deal?
Involved, actually. You're gonna see it's not too tragic. So it starts with some cake flour.
The eating of them is the tragic part because they're going down.
So a bit of cake flour, then we add sugar because we want a slightly sweet and enriched dough. Yeah. And then active dry yeast goes in there. So we mix that around. Then what I know, I've just realized literally when we just came back, is that I'm missing my butter. But what you do at this stage is you rub in the butter. So just soften butter, just rub it in.
Ease it in, okay? Room temperature.
But you could, actually, even if you left out the butter, this recipe would still work.
It's still rock
That's
and roll.
How bomb
That's how good
it is,
you are.
Right? Okay. So eggs and a bit of milk. So this is our wet ingredients. Like I said, it's an enriched dough, which is why we're using milk and eggs just to add extra decadence.
Why is the dough enriched?
It's enriched because it's got rich ingredients
but
in it.
Why do you want it to be enriched?
Just because, you know, it's a donut. You want it to be more than just, you know, bread.
Bread.
Yeah, you want it to be extra delicious, right? Okay, so then one in the center.
Bread would be tragic. That would be tragic.
Well, it wouldn't. I mean, I like a bit of bread in my life. Okay, so mix that together until it forms a dough. You could do this in a machine. Once it comes together, which it will, you knead it for 10 minutes until it's elastic. Then you'll cover it, leave it to prove. Look at you,
right? I know, man.
Leave it
you want then that activated yeast to have an opportunity to go
to
work.
Right?
Yeah.
Then once it's proved, you'll roll it out or separate it into balls. This recipe will make about 20 donuts, so you've got plenty for your family and
just
friends.
Just enough.
Just enough for yourself. And then leave these to prove as well. So you can make them as big or as little as you want. Obviously, that depends on the number. Then on the number that you want. Then preheat your oil to about 180, 185 degrees. So you want to cook these pretty gently so that they cook on the inside as well as the outside. So you can see this is how you tell that oil is not
ready.
Hot enough.
Okay.
You see?
That's almost,
that's just absorbing
that
oil.
Would have almost been tragic. Okay, but thankfully.
But you can see the bubbles are starting to form. So it just needed a little bit longer to get hot. So brown those up. So they will cook for quite a while. So they'll be in there for at least
because you want them to cook through, yeah.
Exactly. So once they brown on one side, turn them over. Then once they come out of the fryer, drain them on kitchen paper. Then you dust them in cinnamon sugar.
Of course.
I use a cup of sugar to about 2 tablespoons of ground cinnamon.
To get the balance,
it's up to you how much cinnamon you like.
You like a bit more spice.
So now you're going to fill that piping bag with some Clover Classic Custard.
And of course, the keyword here is sweet to 33728. Look at that gloopy deliciousness.
Look at that. Okay, that's good. And then just gather the piping bag for me. I'm just going to cut a hole in this, or a gap in this, rather.
Cool.
Just so I can get my piping bag in there.
Without.
There you go. And then you're going to cut a hole in the piping bag.
I don't want to lose any of that deliciousness. Okay. How big a hole are you looking for in this piping bag?
Not too big. I want it to fit into this hole.
Okay.
This one.
So out there.
There you go.
Dun, dun, dun.
Fantastic. So then you go. There you go. So get it right in there. There you go. Oh. Now squeeze. Squeeze until it's resistance. Oh, now you know it's filled.
Oh, that was resistance. So again, the keyword here is sweet. 233728. As we continue to fill these little. Get in there.
So yeah, get it right in.
And
then squeeze.
Come on.
And oh, it's coming out the top.
More delicious from us. One more. There we go.
There you go.
Yay. So again, the keyword here is sweet to 233728. And you can be recreating this incredibly delicious awesomeness. We're going to give it a taste test now while you continue to fill and spread.
Yes.
Custody love across our studio, made with love by Clover and our Zozo.
Yay.
Clover Classic, the creamy taste that takes you back. Made with love by Clover.
Made with love by Clover.
We're going to take the quickest of ad breaks, just long enough for us to do a little taste test here. When we return, it's time for our Friday dance. Mm. Oh, you didn't even hold back. You didn't even wait there. Mm. Boom. Oh, yum.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show. It's Expresso right here on SABC3. Now, we're going to turn our eye to something that happened a little while ago, about a month ago to be exact, and we've been waiting for the perfect opportunity to discuss it with our favorite foodie, chef and cookbook author, Zola Nene, who herself hasn't been here for a while, but you know she's making up for that by being here right now. So we've been enjoying time spent with you.
I love being here. You know this.
But we're going to throw you into the hot seat for a little bit. We need to talk about this thing that happened about a month ago.
Yes.
And do you want to put it into context? Why did it shake up the culinary and Cape Town world so much?
Okay, well, let's talk about what the incident was. So a local foodie was doing an insert for an international food channel. Mm-hmm. And she showed people, showed in inverted commas, how to make a Gatsby. Her version of the Gatsby included plum chutney. Mm. It was served on ciabatta loaf. Mm. It had wilted spinach on it and chickpea curry. Now, that was the incident. And obviously, you know, Cape Townians especially were outraged. So let me tell you why. I mean, you could also tell me why, because you're a Cape Town.
100%, but I'll let you go first. Yeah.
Well, okay, so everybody is allowed to reinterpret dishes. We all do it. We all appropriate dishes. It's all about the context, right? Mm. So what happened here is she went on an international platform and she said, this is what a Gatsby is. Now, people who don't know anything about South African food are going to take that as word.
100%.
And it's all about giving things context. So had she said, there is a dish that we have in South Africa. It's called a Gatsby. It was, you know, created by Mr. Panda. he created this dish, and this is what it authentically is. This is my version. Yeah. Nobody would have had any issues.
Yeah.
But to go and not give it context and then sell it as what it is, and then people all around the world are going to think that is a Gatsby. So they come to South Africa and they actually try an authentic Gatsby. They're going to be like, oh, but this isn't what a Gatsby is. Do you know what
better.
I mean? So it's all about context. And so nobody is slamming her for being original and trying to recreate something. It's all about misappropriation.
Exactly.
And that's what that was an example
of. That was an example of that. And when I was watching it, it looked more to me like a curry sandwich or a bunny chow with a lack of identity.
Okay,
I don't know.
You can't call it a bunny chow. Okay.
Exactly, but there was curry and there was bread. So you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We're making trouble here, okay?
But it was a sandwich.
It was a sandwich,
a perfectly delicious looking sandwich, but it was not a Gatsby.
Exactly. I mean, if you look at this, this is your revised Gatsby. I mean, you've got like the meat at the bottom, you've got the chips, you've got the onions, you've got the everything. That is the essentials of what a Gatsby is.
And down to the bread, you know, Gatsby bread has to be soft so that
it's sort of... no chia butter.
It's not hard chia butter. Yeah. It's got to be sort of squeezy so that it all melts together.
You've got to be able to cut it up into four,
share it. It's got to ooze everywhere. So that was something that people were up in arms about.
Okay, definitely. Like you said, that this is the misappropriation
of food. Misappropriation
of food
culture.
We love that you thought of a new way of doing the Gatsby, but context is everything.
Context is everything, especially with a cuisine like South Africa where it's not as well known. So, for example, we appropriate all sorts of dishes.
Sushi. Americans have done it.
I mean, what we know is sushi is Californian sushi. It's not even Japanese sushi.
Exactly.
But the appropriation of this dish has led to people wanting to educate themselves on Japanese culture.
Exactly.
I mean, everybody knows it takes 7 years for a Japanese chef to learn how to make rice, etc. But because South African cuisine is so new to the world, we need to tell our story the right way.
Yeah, I agree with you. That's why she is the expert. Wow. So excuse the pun, but this has definitely been some food for thought. Let's continue the conversation with you, South Africa. What other foods do you think and know has been misappropriated in parts of the world other than where it originated? You can let us know on our social media platforms.
Well, listen, the fun and games do not end on your Feel Good Breakfast show. Now, we love our Clover Classic custard so much, we always have to make sure we get the very, very last drop out. Now, Lana's already gone as low as she can go. Now, we're going to put you through another game of our Clover Classic Custard Last Drop Squeeze Challenge. Are you guys ready?
I'm ready. I love my custards. I ain't wasting a drop.
Oh, my
gosh. I hope you're ready, eh? Use any tool that we need.
Any tool. So, Lana, as you can see in front of us, there's some tools in front of us. You are welcome to use anything, including the two little chopsticks that I'm using.
Okay. You were going to say
the
stabbing sticks.
The aim is to get as much custard out of your Clover
Classic
bowl.
Okay.
Are you guys ready?
I'm ready.
So we're going to put the timer on in 3, 2, 1, go.
Go for it.
There we go. You've got 45 seconds on the clock. Let's see who can... Ooh, Lana's going for the straw.
Are you drinking it straight off the
She's just drinking her Clover
Classic. It's not long enough.
You see.
I would suggest maybe just squeeze it.
You're allowed to have just custard if you want.
Okay,
now we start with the squash maneuver.
Go for it. Let's see who can get...
The custard is fine.
Look at Graham. He's busy getting...
Come on,
Graham.
The squash maneuver. Come on.
Okay. Guys,
we've got about 3 seconds left on the clock.
Come on.
See who can get the very, very last drop out.
Come on.
I'm super impressed with what I'm seeing on my right-hand side.
This technique.
Now we put a celeb up against our Espresso presenters. Five.
Get in there! Get in there, you! Get in!
Don't do it!
One, that's it, your time's done.
Boom!
That's it, Lana. Okay. Ooh, he's got custard on that. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, I am the person that calls it, and you know what? I was super impressed with how you first had a few sips of your...
I just wanted to make sure it was good.
It is, eh?
The challenge started and Lana decided, no, she's going to take a straw and try some of the Clover Classic custard. Well done. I have to... Give it to Graham.
It is pretty straightforward. And I even injured myself with a knife. Did you see how I quickly put the knife down? Well then, that was a good challenge.
Oh my God. Al's for Lana.
Okay. No, I love it.
There we have. Well done. Graham, you are the champ in this one.
Thank you so
of course.
Much.
Don't miss it because we'll put more celebs up in our Clover Classic Custard Challenge.
Clover Classic, the creamy taste that takes you back. Made with love by Clover.
Made with love by Clover.
Hello, Joburg. Your time has finally come because the presenter search on three auditions have officially kicked off and the queues have started. Now, the gates opened at 8 a.m. this morning at the Wanderers Stadium in Johannesburg, and auditions will also be running tomorrow and Sunday, so you have absolutely no excuse not to get down there. So all you have to do is register at the gate and prepare a 15-second link that will wow the judges. Joburg is notorious for producing some of the best talent that our country has to offer, so you need to bring your A-game. 5FM will be broadcasting live from the auditions, and there will also be a whole host of famous faces wandering around scouting some talent, so you don't want to miss out on this amazing opportunity. This is your time to shine, and for more details and what to expect, you can visit Presenter Search on 3 on Facebook, Twitter or Instagram. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back after this. Princess, where's that coffee girl?
For kids fighting a battle against cancer, even a little goes such a long way. Show them that, hey, we're here with you. Join us on Expresso Thursday the 26th of April for our special telethon to help secure the next Clover NutriKids Chalk Home. All funds raised go towards a brand new chalk house, there for families and...
So, Gymnasium, you just stay safe.
For kids fighting a battle against cancer, even a little goes such a long way. Show them that, hey, we're here with you. Join us on Expresso Thursday the 26th of April for our special telethon to help secure the next Clover NutriKids Chalk Home. All funds raised go towards a brand new chalk house, there for families and children bravely fighting cancer. So, join the Expresso Telethon April 26th from 6:30 to 9 a.m. on SABC 3. The stage is yours.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Oh, welcome back as we enter our final stands on what has been an amazing Friday, an amazing week, and we're going to round it off in style with the Triality Dance Collective. Sinead and Liam, thank you so much for joining us, guys.
Pleasure.
We love our Friday dance here, but even more so, our viewers love our Friday dance. So we try to explore our creative side. We cover every range. How would you describe the kind of performance that you guys put together? What is the Triality Dance Collective all about?
Well, we are a collaborative dance performance. We started training at the Waterfront Theatre College together.
Oh, cool.
And we put all our ideas together and we thought we had something really special on our hands. So it's basically a network or platform where we can create, inspire and perform our own work or collaborate with other performers and just to get out there and inspire and do what we love.
So you have got, from what I've seen with you guys warming up, a beautiful piece for us this morning. Describe a little bit about what you're going to put together as part of this collaborative effort.
Well, we've got, we're both very diversified dancers. I'm hip-hop, she contemporary, so we've kind of fused the two pieces together.
It's like a movie script. He was hip hop. She was contemporary. That's awesome.
To a local track. So yeah, we hope you guys enjoy it.
I think we will enjoy it. Ladies and gentlemen, it's an opportunity now for you to stretch a little bit at home, get yourself involved in our Friday dance. It is the Triality Dance Collective. Take it away, guys. Join the Friday dance, but I just couldn't see a gap. I wanted a leap and you to just catch me in my arms. But dude, that was amazing for a hip hop kid. That wasn't bad, you guys.
Thank you.
If people want to kind of join what you guys are doing and support this collaborative effort, how can people get in touch with you guys, especially young dancers? How do they connect?
We've got an Instagram and Facebook page. It's Triality.
At Triality Collective on both Facebook and Instagram.
So, that's the one.
Go and be inspired. Check out what they're doing online. But that was amazing. Thank you so much, guys. What a way to start off a brilliant week.
Yay! It's Zola Day today. We've loved having you here, Zola. We've loved having you here, Lara. Lara Croft.
I mean, maybe.
You are the South African Lara Croft. We love it. All right, so guys, let's talk about what's happening on Monday. Our relationship talk is going to be lit.
Why?
You need to be ready because we're going to talk about how to know that you have fallen out of love with your partner.
Surely you know if you know, man. Surely you know.
Like some people don't know that they know that they know
it. They don't know.
Just going from A to B, basically.
Well, we're also going to spend some time in the kitchen on Monday. We're going to be making Moroccan couscous. You do not want to miss out on that.
And then we're going to tackle, I think, something that is all too real in so many families' lives at the moment, eating disorders within teens. And that is a conversation I think not just those affected by it, but all of us need to develop a little bit of empathy so we can break some of those stigmas attached. So it's going to be an awesome week like this week was. Thank you so much. Lana, please come back on the show again. We'll tackle you with custard. We'll do it all, man.
And Joburg, we'll see you this weekend. We're on our way, baby. Present us on 3. We'll see you soon.
Have an awesome weekend. We love you.
You made me say that.
Espresso Morning Show, made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.